I dare you. I double dare you, motherfucker. Say what one more damn time.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. What?
Yeah, destroy, destroy.
What month?
The Opie and Anthony Show.
And welcome to the Opie and Anthony Show for today.
Hello.
You can get a hold of us by calling us toll-free, 877-692-1027. Oi. We had to rush into the studio. We almost didn't make it in time, right, Anthony?
Yeah.
We were too busy watching Bob Crane porno
old
films.
50s Bob Crane. You might remember him as Hogan from Hogan's Heroes. And of course, everyone, I guess, knows the story. He ended up getting bludgeoned to death in Arizona back in 1978. A lot of people are saying it was because of his sexploits. Might have banged some broad that belonged to someone else. And he wound up dying for it. But in between the time, before he died, he was filming. Old-fashioned film.
Yeah, he was really
screwing.
Really into, taping himself having sex.
And thank God for his son, who felt it necessary to take these films and put them on the internet for money.
So we could all check out Bob Crane having sex.
How much do you think he hated his dad?
Bob Crane getting Hummers. Bob Crane mounting girls doggy style.
Bob Crane doggy style. Bob Crane missionary. Bob Crane Hummers. Bob Crane going down on the peach. Bob Crane fondling. Bob Crane gangbangs. It's amazing. All grainy black and white film clips.
So his son is, I think his son's name is Scotty. Scotty Crane?
Scotty Crane.
He's an interesting fella. He's going to be on our show in like a week or so, Anthony.
How do you feel about your father that you look at films of him having sex and then decide to just make them public?
You know, Rick has his phone number. Get Rick. We should at least get the Scotty Crane on the air just for a couple minutes just to tease his appearance on our show next week.
Yeah, he's supposed to come in live.
Rick, can you call up Scotty and just get him on for like 30 seconds?
I tried to do that twice already today, especially the second time when I got the password and everything. He doesn't want to come on yet.
Tell him if he doesn't come on, we're going to give out then he'll just change that password.
Yeah. Okay, I know how that works.
Damn.
He says he doesn't want to, because he's coming in next Friday.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to dilute his appearance. He wants to save all the good stuff for one big money
shot. This guy will...
Money shot.
Yeah, he will say it all. He will not hold back.
You see Bob Crane's junk in all its glory.
Yeesh.
Oh, my God. He has a peeler, by the way. Who knew that? Bob Crane had a peeler.
Bob Crane has a peeler?
He has a cannoli.
Yeah. Ugh. Yeah, that was pretty twisted.
Hogan!
To see Bob Crane get the 50s Hummer was pretty funny.
Oh. And then when he,
they had different techniques back then, I noticed.
You gotta compensate for the big 70s Earth Mama muff that they had. And he's digging more tunnels with these, chicks than he was in Hogan's Heroes, man. He was plowing. Oh. Big gut hanging over her ass. Really disturbing to watch.
It's pretty twisted.
Yeah.
Billy, what's going on?
Hey,
Billy.
Yeah, they used to have the videos on when his son was there. They used to be hanging out in the room. He used to have the videos on.
He'd let his son watch with him?
He wasn't actually watching it, but they were on. They were hanging out. He was talking about it.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, Billy. Thank you.
All right.
Can we get the snapshot of Bob Crane getting a Hummer on FoundryMusic.com?
Yeah, you got to kind of lift it.
Can we do that, Steve? We're going to have the guy on the air. We're going to sell him a ton of memberships.
Can someone show me where it is?
Yeah, we could do that.
What, right. Bob Crane's schlong?
Well, which one you want to...
Presently.
Yeah, I guess the Hummer one.
We got to share with our listeners. We got to give them just a little taste.
The Hummer one.
Shouldn't say that. A little piece.
Oh.
A little piece of Bob Crane.
Piece.
A little piece of Bob Crane getting a Hummer. We'll put it on FoundryMusic.com in a little while, because Steve's busy right now. So
what are you, gay?
So don't even, check right now.
Yeah.
FoundryMusic.com.
Friggin' fag, you want to make out or something?
So which one you want to give the folks?
I guess the Hummer one's the best, because you actually see Bob Crane's face,
all right,
his junk, and one of his girls.
Steve, come here. This is what you do. We'll put the still shot on FoundryMusic.com, and then underneath it, you know, it's a little tease, and you tell everyone, make sure you listen to Opie and Anthony next Friday when Scotty Crane... Bob's son comes on the Opie and Anthony show.
Fair enough.
And then they won't be pissed off at us because we're advertising the appearance. And
Did you see the part where Bob Crane was dining on the girl's peach?
Yeah.
Couldn't even be called a peach. It was just a Wookiee down there.
It was it was a pull rack filled with Afro hair.
Yeah, but when he started working it, and then he pulled his head away. You ever see when a dog's got really bad fleas and they just lick an area for a long time and the hair gets that cowlick curl, but it's all soaking wet? There you go. There you go.
I don't know what you're describing right there.
Blah.
So, all right, we'll get that up on foundrymusic.com. Chris, what's going on?
Yeah, Bob Crane, he used to show the pitches, like he would have like vacation pitches at like a dinner party, yeah. And he'd be like, oh, this is the Grand Canyon, this is the Alamo, and this is some chick I banged in Houston.
I believe it.
That's what he used to do. He used to show them. The kids, the son, he saw it, the wife knew about it, and all of that.
I believe
it. He was off the wall.
He was banging everyone. I mean, there's gangbang photos on this website
with all these 70s people. Big guy with big afro, and he's just slamming some chick, and Bob Crane is slamming her.
All right, I know who could help us out. My friend BJ, who does a radio show in Seattle.
BJ, come on, is this a joke?
No. BJ Shea.
Yeah.
He was the one who turned me on to Scotty Crane. He goes, you got to get this guy on the air. He'll say everything.
Oh, so maybe we could get some details from him.
Yeah.
Secondhand.
Can you try to find BJ? I forgot what station he's on out there.
I have his number back in the
You
office.
Do?
I think so.
Yeah, give him a call.
Pick him up.
He's also got that book, too, he's bringing next week.
What book?
The book of all the still shots.
This guy is
not only do you see still shots on the website,
right.
But he's got even more, even like the death scene and everything.
Wow,
he's got
really?
A whole book of pictures of his pops.
Yeah.
Like the cops' pictures that they took at the hotel when they found him dead.
Yep.
Just his head was caved in. Someone beat him to death with his own tripod for some of the camera equipment that he... Because he used to set up all these cameras, and back then it was a little tougher than it is today. You know, you got videos now. Everyone can make their own porno.
And he was banging like a lot of other celebrities' wives.
No, right. It's obvious.
And somebody came in the hotel room, his camera equipment there. He was obviously doing something and just caved his skull in and beat him senseless and dead.
All right, we're going to try to get our pal BJ on the line because he interviewed him already. Because now I just need to talk to Scotty Crane.
You know, he did start his career as a radio DJ, Opie. So,
Bob Crane?
One of the long line of illustrious radio DJs that ended up dead for some kind of sex scandal.
Hey, Nick, what's going on?
Hey, what's up, O&A? How you doing?
Doing all right.
Hey, I just moved down to D.C. from Long Island. I've been on Long Island my whole life. And all we got down in D.C. is Don and Mike, and I hate them.
What about the grease man?
They're the worst. And I'm wondering when you guys are coming down. I keep hearing you're moving around now.
We're working on some things for the Washington area.
All right, yeah, because it sucks. They're all politically correct.
Yeah.
They don't say anything controversial at all.
Yes, that's right. The grease man never said anything controversially. Water doodle, linger longer, bone dry.
Are you listening to the grease man down there?
No, it's Don and Mike from Moscow.
No, we know Don and Mike. They're on here right after us in New York. But the grease man, we were just listening to him on the internet.
Oh, my God.
He he bought time on, I think it's a Korean-owned station.
This is what he had to do. The poor grease man. Everyone knows who the grease man is, whether he's been in your city or not. He was the DJ that said, no wonder they dragged them behind trucks.
That was after he was listening to Lauryn Hill's latest song at the time.
Listening to Lauryn Hill's song. I guess he didn't like the song. It was right after that black guy was dragged by a couple of hillbillies down south in the pickup truck and killed him. And the grease man thought it would be funny to play a little bit of a Lauryn Hill song that was nominated for an award, and come out of it and just say, hey, no wonder they drag him behind trucks there. Whoa, hey, where's this big hook coming in, grabbing me out of the studio? Hey, what are you doing here?
Yeah, he was
gone. So then he went on his apologize tour, where he went to all the black stations around the country going, you know, I'm not a racist, and I apologize if I've hurt anybody's feelings. Waddle doodle.
Well, no one really bought the apology because
no one bought it.
No one will hire him on regular radio.
No.
So now he buys his own time on a radio station.
Like an infomercial. You could buy, if you have money up front, you can buy time on a radio station. Like you hear commercials, only it's a 4-hour long commercial. So he buys the time, but then he's got to recoup the money. How he does this, he goes out and he
he sells his airtime.
He sells his own, yeah.
He goes out, he goes to, you know, a chicken place or something and says,
we heard one for a barbecue joint.
Barbecue, the Big Q barbecue. Make sure you go down to the Big Q barbecue and get some of those ribs. I hear the colored folk like it. Wada doodle. Oops, what did I say? Hey, it's my own show. My own time.
Linger longer.
Linger longer. And he's going off on one of these bits. I hadn't heard the Grease Man in so long, but it took a second for me to remember how painful it was to listen to. There I was, in Vietnam, shooting gooks. Wada-doodle, there's another slippery little yellow gook, dead, at the hands of me, the Grease Man. Watch out, another slope-headed gook. There it is, I fired my weapon, slinging lead, all the time, killing gookage. Wada-doodle. More machine gun for you. Get out of here, you slimy little yellow slope. And speaking of yellow slopes, make sure to head down to Wang's Chinese Kitchen on Main Street. I just came back from there, and they gave me some money to mention it. Got to pay for this airtime. Waddle doodle. And all you Negroes, go to the rib joints. The Big Q rib joint, barbecued ribs for all the colored. Waddle doodle.
Bone dry.
Bone dry, snarlin's.
I was listening for 2 minutes. I'm just like, watching Bob Crane porno and listening to the Grease
Man.
Yeah,
we had a,
it was a surreal,
we had a very weird hour before the show today.
Waddle doodle.
The Bob Crane stuff, priceless.
Yes, sir. And make sure you head down to, Bob's Chili Kitchen for the best chili this side of dirty, filthy Mexico. Where the dirty, filthy Mexicans live, there. Bone dry, waddle doodle, snarlins, linger longer, gooks. Watch out, more gooks coming up, And there I was, in my foxhole, hunkering down as the gook invasion came over. So I shot him and then pulled my claymores, blowing up all the little yellow gooks, leaving gook pieces, all over the place. Gook pieces. Bone dry,
Unbelievable. It's entrenched in my head now. I can't get the Grease Man out of
here.
That
guy used to say, linger longer.
Make sure you linger longer. Yeah.
And then he starts singing songs, and no one even knows what the hell he's talking about.
Yeah. Let's go to Joe. Joe, what's going on, man?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Is this what you call show prep?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, we don't prepare for our show. It's a known fact.
We hang out.
All the other radio shows, they work their balls off before their show. We
just up at the crack of noon, huh?
We just kind of surf the internet and you know, throw things around in our office. Today it was Bob Crane porno and checking out the Grease Man doing a show on a Korean radio station.
Wada doodle.
Yeah.
Later.
All right, man. We have John Valby outside the studio waiting to come in, Anthony.
Nino Grease Manelli. That was my name that I...
Someone just emailed that in.
He did. He was like, and there I was. I was a cop on the Washington, D.C. Police Department. Nino Grease Manelli.
Nino Grease Manelli.
Nino. Yes, named myself after a Dago. Greasy Wop Dago. And speaking of Greasy Wop Dagos, make sure you head down to Pine Street for the great pizza at Dago's Pizza. Cha-ching! More money. Okay, I paid for the first 15 minutes of the show. Now I gotta pay for 3 hours 45 minutes more. Okay, I'm gonna put a record on and go out and try to sell more time on my show where... Waddle doodle. Bone dry!
We gotta play Grease Man Crayolas now.
Ah, Crayola.
Crayola!
Crayola crayons! Multinational. Waddle.
Doodle.
Doodle!
The politically incorrect crayons.
Snarlins.
From Crayola. Check this out.
Yadda-doo-deedle-day. Yadda-doddle. Yadda-dee.
Now, Grease Man, when are you...
Snarlins. I was being offensive. Yadda-doodle-dee. Gobbledygoo.
Grease Man, you really got to get another job because we're sick of having you on our show here.
Waddle-daddle, please hire me.
No.
Somebody hire me, the Grease Man, for a radio show.
Well, I hear that you're looking at a job for Crayola. With Crayola, I should
say. Well, actually, the Grease Man is coming out with his own line of crayons. Racially insensitive crayons. I looked in the paper this morning. I saw, the Grease Man saw, that Crayola
yeah.
is removing Indian Red Day.
Yes.
From their box of crayons.
Because it's not politically correct and they don't want to tick off any people.
Insensitive.
Right.
To the Indians.
That's right.
As we like to call them, the cowboy killers. I remember as a cowboy slinging lead against the Indians, their arrows whooshing over my head. The Redskin. But yes, very, very upset about Indian Red in the crayon box.
Yeah.
So Crayola pulled it.
Well, they're going to continue making the color. They want people to come up with a new name for that color.
Yeah. Let's see. How about Kemosabe? Yeah. Yaddle doodle. Snarling. Bone dry. Yeah.
You're just not politically correct, Greaseman.
Well, I'm hoping to get some money with my new crayon line.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. Greaseola crayons.
Could you
name it? The sharpener on the side makes the crayons as pointy as my head. Yaddle daddle. Bone dry. Yeah.
Now, could you name some of the crayons that you will be offering?
Well, let's say a young child. A little young waif wants to draw the sun.
Oh, that's nice.
Nice bright sun.
Sure.
Little picture in his kindergarten class. You know what color he'd use?
Huh.
In the Greaseola crayon set?
What?
Chink yellow. Yaddle daddle. Just a big circle. You can get color in with some chink yellow. Yaddle daddle. And of course, you can't complete the scene without maybe some flowers basking in the heat of that chink yellow sun.
Well, that would be nice, sure.
Right, so you draw some tulips.
Okay.
And of course, you use homo pink. Homo pink. A shade of pink loved by bone smugglers everywhere. Yaddle diddle. Doodle die. How about Polish purple?
Ah, Polish purple sounds neat.
Polish purple.
Why Polish purple, though?
Well, look, it's green. Yiddle diddle die. The crazy Polacks can't get the colors right there. Oh, my. Mick green.
Mick green,
yes,
okay.
The color of the shamrocks.
That's right.
Mick green, Mick green, bone dry, yeah. Yaddle daddle.
Wow.
And, of course, wetback brown.
Of course.
And then, of course, I have the special Italian crayon there.
And what's that?
Look, it's a grease pencil. Greasy little Dago pencil. Yaddle deedle doodle die. Bone dry.
Very nice.
Oops, I'm being removed from my seat.
Hey.
By CBS Brass. Yeah. Oh, it's happening again, Dad. Whoa.
They're yanking him out of the studio again.
Whoa, look at that. CBS boss has dragged him out again. He's going to go back on his apology tour.
Greaseola crayons.
Boy.
That's kind of cute, huh?
A little insensitive there.
Big time. All right.
I love that bit.
Love that one.
Hubbardy goo goo.
Yeah. Let's go to Willie. Willie, what's going on?
What's up, guys? How you doing?
All right, man.
Hey, I'm glad I'm giving you guys a chance, you know, because I was driving home from work, and I'm from Philly. Driving home from work, and I turned on my YSP channel, and I heard you guys. I'm thinking, what the hell is this?
Yes, that is the first reaction.
And I'll tell you what, I've been listening to you ever since. I look forward to you guys coming on.
What do you think this is, South Park? You can't say that word on radio.
Now everyone thinks they could say the S word because of South Park.
Yeah.
Last night.
Can't
you guys
got
to be cracking. I'll just listen to the Greaseman gig there.
Oh, cool.
You guys are good. Keep it up.
We were supposed to go to Babe Fest tonight in Philly, but we have a prior engagement we have to take care of.
You're going to piss the guys off.
Well, Babe Fest is going to rock tonight in Philadelphia.
Yeah,
so have fun, all right?
Thanks, guys.
All right, Willie.
Bye.
All right, Anthony, we got to take a quick break here. Toll free, 877-692-1027. John Valby outside the studio. That's our prior engagement. We're going to go see him on Long Island tonight. MLK, he's in Wantagh. It's going to be a lot of fun. If you've never heard John Valby on the radio before,
yeah,
I think you're going to want to stick around.
Absolutely.
Syndication now.
Opie and Anthony are finally syndicated.
Woo-hoo!
And to celebrate, they're going to be at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island tonight with Dr. Dirty, Mr. John Valby. The show starts at 9 p.m., so come on down and hang with the guys tonight at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island. From 102.7.
WNEW 102.7. WNEW is the sports guys at 5 a.m. The radio chick at 9. Ron and Fez at noon. Opie and Anthony at 3. Don and Mike at 7.
Next time on a very special Ron and Fez.
The guys start making their plans for summer.
What are you doing this summer, Ron?
I'm thinking about taking the family out west. How about you?
Well, I'd love to see that thing that shoots off every hour on the hour.
Old Faithful?
No, Miguel. He's a Cuban boy I know in Miami. You can certainly call him Old Faithful.
Here's an idea. How about taking a vacation from being a filthy sucker?
All on the next Ron and Fez.
Middays, noon to 3, 1027. WNEW.
Hey. Quick. Hey, man. Sorry. John Valby distracted us. Anthony Sobey Beverages.
Yes, Sobey, the leader in healthy refreshment. All Sobey Beverages specially formulated to uplift the mind, body, and spirit. Great tasting teas and fruit blends that have been enhanced with herbs and other natural supplements. Shut up.
This week's flavor, Sobey derived from the power line. Great tasting strawberry grape punch with passion-producing herbs. All kinds of stuff in there to increase the sex drive. Sobey's got the unique packaging. It's the 20-ounce lizard embossed glass bottles. And the labels that feature the Sobey lizard. Under each bottle cap, there's a different lizard slogan. And if you want to find out more info about Sobey, go to SobeyBev.com or call up their lizard line, 1-800-588-0548. And be on the lookout for the Sobey Lizard Love Bus, spreading the Sobey experience all over the country. Grab a Sobey and drain the lizard. Sobey Beverages.
Anytime, Einstein.
The Opie and Anthony Show.
The show blows.
The Opie and Anthony Show.
Blows. Show blows monkey ass.
The Opie and Anthony Show.
Nice. We're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. Toll free, 877-692-1027. Look who's in the studio, Anthony. John Valby.
Hey.
John Valby.
How are ya?
John Valby playing tonight at Mulcahy's in Wausau. We're all going right after the show. We're going to have a ball. Jim Norton's going to open up and do a few minutes of comedy.
Oh.
We're going to hit the stage, and then Valby's going to do what he does best. Right, John?
Yeah, I'm ready, man. I'm looking forward to this thing.
Now,
it's going to be fun.
Now you got your keyboard in front of you.
I do. This is the only thing I can get out of
yeah,
the air
I know.
Here, you know?
Usually we have to bleep out of you. Well, we're going to try. John comes in, I don't know, like three or four times a year. And he sings his songs, and we dump out of most of his songs.
And then the next day, we get to put the bleeps in.
Right. They don't call him Dr. Dirty for nothing. Have you been working on some clean stuff, John?
Maybe. You know, I have a limerick I want to try.
Yeah?
It, you know, it goes, let me see. Women like to size up a man's staff, then chit-chat and get a good laugh. But since that Komodo dragon, Sharon Stone's been bragging that her man has a foot and a half. Yeah. Sharon Stone is a federally protected wetland.
Hey, I think that
might have made it. You know?
Sure.
Yeah.
I think you're one for one so far. That's good.
You know, the thing I'm most excited about is it's coming out today is a movie that we made right here in this studio with you guys.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
There's the poster in front of us. John Valby, Dr. Dirty, O&A, and TNA.
And TNA.
Yeah. Yeah, you filmed the last few appearances on our show and made a tape out of it. And it looks really good.
Yeah, and Gary Tepper did it, and man, he did a great job. Cecil B. DeMille, I call him now. You know, he's the cuts were really good, and you know, you guys were funny too.
So, no, what's great about it is this is the unedited version.
Because,
the cameras were rolling when John was singing all the songs that we had to dump out on our show.
Yeah, and seeing us frantically go back and forth trying to find what we could get in and stuff.
Yeah,
it was neat.
And you got some footage of you in concert as well?
Yes.
Nice.
Yeah.
Our listeners are going to want this. I'm telling you right now. Is there any way they can
Get
it?
We're going to have some of them tonight at Mulcahy's, and it just got finished last night, so we're printing them up as fast as we can.
They only have 50 copies. I started laughing at them. 50 copies.
Well, there's only going to be about 20, 30 people there tonight, right?
Sure. There's going to be at least 1,500 people there tonight, John.
Yeah.
Are you ready for that?
I'm ready. Let's rock, man. Right. This is going to be good. And this is the longest day of the year, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That it is.
Do you have a song about that? I don't know where he was going.
Yeah. I wasn't going to. My wife told me it was going to be really weird tonight.
Yeah.
And she wanted me to report on that.
Uh-huh.
She believes in that, you know, psychic forces and all that kind of stuff.
Oh, the astrology
thinking,
and all
yeah,
that.
Yeah, all that. The forces of the planet is in opposition.
Call me now. I'm Dr. Dirty's wife. Call me now for your free psychic reading.
I played in a grease man thing once in Maryland.
Dr. Dirty.
On the side of a hill there,
John
Valby. He finally came down, yeah.
That's cool. Let's try another song. We're one for one.
Let's do a little Hey Bob Rebo. Hey Bob Rebo. Oh, my goddamn outhouse blues. Mama's in jail, papa's on a bail, sister's on a corner yelling, stuff's for sale. Hey, Bob Rebo. Hey, Bob Rebo. Oh, my goddamn outhouse blues. Still my favorite. Mama's on the bottom, daddy's on top. Baby's in the corner yelling, sticking to her pop. Hey, Bob Rebo. Hey, Bob Rebo. Oh, my goddamn. How about one more? I know a girl, her name is Pam. She uses a frisbee for a diaphragm. Hey, Bob Rebo. Hey, Bob Rebo.
I think that went through, too.
That may have made it.
Nice. Wow, we're pretty lucky to get two in a row.
I think you're two for two today, John. Chris, what's going on?
Hey, I want to break your record. What does John think about group sex?
Oh, no.
It depends on the group. I don't know. What do you want me to say? How many you want to do at one time? What are you talking
about?
I'm
just looking for the gangbang song.
Of course.
Hey, John, know how we get...
You guys got Chris... Oh, go ahead.
Know how we get away with stuff on our show? We use the alphabet.
Word?
I'm wondering. You could say F, and you could say F or in the A.
Yeah.
F or in the A, and pull it out, C all over her face.
We don't know what that means, see?
Yeah, that's good.
So maybe we could try that with one of your songs. I don't know.
Yank my doodle, it's a dandy. Yank my doodle till I die. Make that wiener shoot some fireworks. Just like the 4th of... Knock, knock!
Who's there?
Krispy Kreme.
Krispy Kreme who?
Krispy Kreme is what the slut has on her face when she wakes up the next morning. After the gangbang, yes she does. After the gangbang. How about this one? Knock, knock!
Who's there?
NSYNC.
NSYNC who?
NSYNC is where she spits whatever little she doesn't swallow. After the gangbang, yes she does. Did it make it? I don't know.
Hell yeah. That made it.
We're going to find out.
How to make it. We don't know what he was talking about.
Yeah, right.
Could be anything.
NSYNC's a group.
Rick?
Yeah. We are three for three.
Oh, nice.
Now people are going to just start saying, oh, John Valby sold out.
Yeah, right.
Three for three, that's never happened.
See, you keep it vague and no one knows what you're singing about.
Right.
Yeah.
Those are perfect examples. Krispy Kreme.
Let me go to Eric. Eric, what's going on?
Hey. Mr. Valby.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I like, I know you did an Elvis Presley medley at one time.
Okay.
Well, isn't that originally from Mr. Floyd? How much do you envy Soupy Sales? Tell me.
Oh,
bastard, you rip-off artist.
Oh, my God. He's trying to say that you rip off Soupy.
You know, when you threw a pie in my face when you came in, I was thinking the same thing.
Soupy Sales.
Wow, that's great.
Good. That's great. I was trying to remember the Elvis songs, and I don't remember doing any of them.
No.
You know?
Not Dr. Dirty.
Maybe Soupy Sales did that.
He's an original.
Soupy Sales.
Man.
People got nerve. Every time they hear something funny, it got to be ripped off from someone else.
That's right.
Well, Jesus.
There's supposed to be only 15 or 16 jokes, and all of them are a form of that. You know?
That's exactly
right.
Hey, Doug, what's going on?
What's up, guys? Let's see if John Valley can go match the Met streak and go 4-for-4.
Now, Doug, all those other songs made it through, right?
Yeah, it's been pretty cool.
All right, cool.
And the best is when he laughs at his own songs, though. It's hysterical. No, that's good. He's laughing, then you make him laugh more.
That's the beer.
Take it easy, guys.
All right.
I met her down in Florida, it's snowing a night like this. I knew that if I stopped to talk, that'd be when nature calls. She said her name was Tammy, she loved to give me head. By now my balls were clammy, but my D was big and red.
You can't say the B word?
The B word.
You were about four dumps deep into that already.
you can't say the P word. You can't say the D word.
The P is...
that one didn't make it. No.
Tinkle. Tinkle didn't make it. The P word for tinkle. Oh,
really?
Yeah, that's one of the ones that...
You can't say pee and vinegar?
Right.
Oh.
That's one of the seven dirty words.
Wow. Sorry, very sorry.
That's all. Oh, no, you were doing very good.
Three out of four.
Now we're back to the starting line.
Oh, that's too bad.
We were doing so well.
We were.
Yes, we were. There we go.
Torn between two lovers, my wife and my own left hand. Believe me, on my wedding night, this is not what I had planned. Born torn between two lovers, but if I had to choose, the sad truth is my effing wife would lose.
I think we're back on track again. Yes,
we're back to one.
Getting ready on the button every time you start playing that keyboard.
I bet our dump guy is sweating.
Yeah,
yeah.
Well, it's a hot
happens
day.
Every time, but right. It's to be expected. Yeah. Come on, know what the guy's all about.
Let me go to Ryan for a second. Ryan, what's up?
Oh, and hey, John, what's going on?
Hey,
listen, I got a quick story to tell you. It goes back to kind of about those porno movies that, you know, the father was letting the kid watch.
We're talking about Bob Crane. Let me fill John Valby in here. Bob Crane from Hogan's Heroes?
Right.
Exactly.
Hold on, Chris. We just spent the last 2 hours watching Bob Crane nail chicks and stuff.
His old 50s videos, because he took videos of him having sex with all these women.
He was the Rob Lowe of his day. Huh?
Yeah, oh, certainly was, right up until someone caved his skull in a hotel room with his own camera tripod.
And you know who?
Hogan?
You know who's putting out all these porno tapes?
Uh-uh.
His own son.
His son.
Wow. Scotty Crane.
Selling them.
He's going to be on our show.
Wow.
So, we were checking out Bob Crane doing gangbangs, getting hummers, eating the peach. It was just... unbelievable.
Big 70s Earth Mama Peach.
So go ahead. All right. Valby's up to speed now. What do you have about that, Ryan?
Yeah. So anyway, his father like got this girlfriend. She's a real hot chick, right? So he's like, I want to set up a video camera and catch my pops banging this girl. So all of us are just dying, you know? So he sets up the camera, and he could tell that they were banging because he's listening out the door. He was trying it for like 3 weeks. Finally, he got it. He's like, he calls me up. He's like, I'm coming over the house. I got the video. We put the video in. All right, she's hot, you know, but he gassed it a little bit too much. You know what I mean? She had a little saggage. So next thing I see, his father's hairy ball bag. I'm like, why am I looking at this? I mean, they got the back view. I'm looking at his crack.
Right,
he's got pimples.
All right, slow down, because they're going to jump out of you. But basically, you watched your friend's father bang.
Right, and the funniest thing is we're watching him for the hot chick. He springs up. He was done in like 30 seconds. So now we're calling Speedy, Quickie, everything when we go to the house.
Quick
he can't
shot.
Figure out the joke.
Quick draw.
Yeah, 151 rules, guys. Be good.
All right, Ryan.
All right.
There you have it. All right, let's go to Jamie. Jamie, what's up?
Hey, I just want to tell John Valby how much I enjoy his music.
Oh,
I am
thank
just,
you.
I've gone to your show maybe twice, and I have just had a blast. I want to say that you, whatever you're doing, it's awesome.
Oh, thank you very much. It makes me feel good.
Yeah, his shows are so entertaining because, I mean, you know, he doesn't have to worry about FCC rules and stuff. He just lets it fly.
Yeah, it's a lot different. So, all right.
And I was so pissed that I was so mad that I couldn't get there tonight. But, all right, I'm enjoying this on the radio. Thank you guys so much.
All right, Jamie.
All right, I'll talk to you later.
Let's see if John could do another one here and get it through, get it past the censors.
Yeah, what was I going to do? Midnight last evening, out by the pond, my fairy godmother went nuts with her wand. She effed up the words, she was half in the bag. Now the pumpkin's a sumo who dresses in drag. Chim chiminy, chim chiminy, chim chim chiri. I got the balls of a rhino, the D of a flea. Chim chiminy, chim chiminy, chim chim chiru. I can see by your face that she effed you up too. I may not have much, but it's enough to F you.
The alphabet works.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. That's a good way around it.
Oh, yeah. Until they take that away from us.
I always thought that they were actually censoring thoughts. You know, in Chicago, they tell me that if you say anything with insertion, like I was trying to do, some girl had two thumbs up from Siskel and Ebert.
Right.
And they wouldn't let me do that.
No.
But some places they do. Like, you guys don't care about thumbs up.
No.
Right?
No, I don't think so. Yeah, that's how good your legal team is.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, right up until we get in trouble for it. Yeah, Tom, what's up?
25 years, big fan. Dr. John, seen you up in Rochester many times. Still have the vinyl records.
Wow.
How about trying Barnacle Bill?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
Use the bees.
Use the alphabet. Let's
see. Yeah, use the
Who's that knocking at my door? Who's that knocking at my door? Who's that knocking at my door? Said the fair young man.
Well, open the door, you effing whore, said Barnacle Bill, a sailor. Open the door, you effing whore, said Barnacle Bill, a sailor.
Shall we go to the dance?
The hell with the dance, and down with your pants, said Barnacle Bill, a sailor. Hell with the dance, down with your pants, said Barnacle Bill, a sailor.
What's that thing between your legs?
Said Barnacle Bill, well, you want to try a semi-sick one?
Yay! What's that dripping down your leg?
Well, shut up, you dope, my rubber broke, said Barnacle Bill, a sailor. Shut up, you dope, my rubber broke, said Barnacle Bill.
I better stop there before I get in trouble. Oh, you won't get in trouble. We will. Oh, I just got the signal. That one didn't make it, John.
Yeah, couple thumbs on that one.
Really?
Damn it.
Are you a little surprised?
I actually am. I thought I used all the right F's and
so did I.
Yeah.
I'm not too familiar with this.
Yeah.
You know, I just say what I want.
That one was a little too obvious.
Like the others weren't. You know?
You're going to ruin it.
Oh, all
right. Let's go to Mike. Mike, what's going on?
Yeah, I was wondering if John could do a couple limericks.
Limericks are always nice.
Sure. Mm. A classic. There once was a young man from Stamboul who had red spots all over his tool. He rushed to the doc, who looked at his seat. Just wipe off the lipstick, you fool. Yeah. Your mother can stall a lawnmower with her bush hair. Another for his work. While they're around by my willy. There once was a priest, and I better not do a religious.
Oh, religion's fine.
Oh, all right. There once was a priest from Dundee who hung a nun's see on a tree. He grabbed her bare ass and performed a high mass that even the Pope came to see. Yeah.
Wait. No. John, you're doing so well.
That is so funny.
You can't say that.
Why not?
What the F? We're all just getting along. It was working out nice.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought that was...
You can't say
You could say your sister's in charge of the splooge towels.
Oh, that was it.
But the splooge. C word for byproduct,
no,
very
no,
frowned
that's,
upon.
That's very frowned
that's
upon.
That's very, very bad. Bad.
I'm,
Ant and I know the rules, John. Yeah.
He's like a crack addict.
That is so funny, yeah.
It's like he can only stay off it so long. Yeah.
Like Robert Downey Jr.
Yeah. You can't help yourself.
Right now he's staggering down the street in his underwear.
Oh, my God. God, that's funny.
How about...
let me go to Jay. Oh, go he's got a question. This is a good question. Jay, what's going on?
Hey, what's up, O&A?
Hey.
What's up? I was watching South Park last night. I was wondering what you guys think about them saying the S-word like 1,000 times on that last night.
I thought it was great.
Yeah, I think it's great that they can get away with that. You know, I wish I could.
Yeah, I think they said it 163 times
yeah.
or something like that.
Yeah, how the hell did they get away with that?
Cable.
Ah.
It's cable, yeah.
Cable TV.
Cool guys, thanks, man.
All right, Jay.
Been listening to you for a while, love you guys.
All right.
It's
later.
Never been illegal for them to say curse words on cable TV. They choose not to because of advertisers and other garbage like that. But they're legally, they can get on and say whatever the hell they want. You're paying for it.
And everyone's talking about South Park today.
Yeah.
Again. 162?
162.
John, you want to try? I know we have to get you out of here in a few minutes because you got to get some Mulcahy's, but want to try another
right.
one?
Right. You want to let me see if I can think of one that I might be able to
squeak by?
I was out on a date in my daddy's car. I picked her up in a wonton bar. I finger F'd her C. She didn't let out a peep. I had my C and he started to spit. But now I'm
it's hard to do, isn't it?
I lost the thought in all those alphabets there.
It's hard to do.
It is. Where? Alphabets. Oh, where can my... no, I how about there once was a young lady from Arden who S'd off a man in a garden. He said, my dear Flo, where does all that stuff go? And she said, I beg your pardon? Yeah. Your grandma gives gummers to plumbers. Sing me another verse. Where's Walls here around by me. Won't be an Anthony on the radio. Won't be an Anthony on the radio. They're gonna make you laugh with the crazy show. But one thing I saw made my pecker go ouch. Won't be doing Anthony on the lesbian couch. Won't be an Anthony, the king and queen of New York.
Okay, terrific.
No, they beat that one out, too.
They should have. Where's the dump guy?
Yeah,
when we
baby.
Need him?
Yeah.
No.
At least wrong. Try again, dumbass.
You bastard.
Very good. Tonight, Mulcahy's.
Right. We have to get you out.
We got to go out and
really
set up and do all that kind of stuff. But
all right. Now, this video that was shot in the studio with us and you.
Yeah.
Where can people get it? I mean, at the club tonight.
Yeah, at the club tonight. And then they can get it on johnnyvalby.com. Or, you know, we ought to set something with you guys where they can get it here, you know.
As soon as we play
a commercial, we'll talk about it.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you'll just have a booth set up somewhere and they'll be able to buy the video tonight?
Right. Absolutely.
Okay.
And it's real good, too. I mean, you know, you guys, that first show especially, we were hot that day. besides, we were using all the stuff that I could get on the air. Now we're getting down to the stuff.
You can't get on the air. Well, we're going to see you tonight. We can't wait.
Oh, me too.
Yeah, John Valby at Mulcahy's in Wantagh tonight. I don't even know if there are tickets available.
Yeah, there's some available.
There's some available?
It's basically, you know, first come, first serve. You got to get your ass down there.
All right, cool. Thank you, John.
Hey, thank you. Great to see you guys again.
We're still stupid. Well, if that's what it takes to get good ratings, we'll continue being stupid.
We don't care.
I've been expecting you to make exactly that asinine statement.
The Opie and Anthony Show. Theater of the Mindless.
Anthony, New Jersey cure.
Listen up, New Jersey drivers. A lot of insurance companies have low premiums. Then you have that first accident. What do? They nail you. He has a cure for what ails your insurance problems. Get it? New Jersey Cure Auto Insurance. If you only have one accident on your record in the last 3 years, you don't pay through the roof. New Jersey Cure, they're direct writer like Geico is, but for New Jersey drivers. So they eliminate the high cost of commissions for the middlemen and agents and whatnot. They've been insuring thousands of responsible Jersey drivers for over a decade, keeping the claims as low as possible. New Jersey Cure forgives drivers for their first two moving violation points. So if you have 4 points on your license, they rate you like you only had two. So say, you know, you blew a light or something like that, or you're speeding. You only get 2 points, even if you have four. 5 minutes it takes to fill out a questionnaire online. NJCure.com. NJCure.com. You get a detailed quote emailed right back to you. Remember, NJCure.com, or you can call them up, 1-800-535-CURE. 1-800-535-CURE.
Howard. By Opie and Anthony. Owned by Infinity Broadcasting. This is 1027 WNEW, New York.
And we're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. Toll free, 877-692-1027. I think John Valby went pretty well today.
Yeah. Unreal. There's very limited things he can do on the air.
Yeah, we're trying to teach him to clean it up, but he'll never learn. If you're in the area, check out the uncensored John Valby Show tonight at Mulcahy's in Wantagh. We're all going to be there. Mario Cantone on the way, Louis Black on the way. It's going to be a lot of fun in the studio with
get
those two
your
guys.
Get balls out.
We got an email from Chicago, Anthony.
We did?
Chicago.
How are things going over there?
We've been on in Chicago 3 days now.
3 days.
This letter was written after 2 days.
Seems like just yesterday.
Or we've done three, whatever. Okay, this guy writes, hi, just a quick note to let you know that this listener will not be tuning in to your new weeknight show. Opie and Andy.
Andy? That old gag.
I love every other show on CKG, but these new guys are nasty, and I'm usually pretty hard to offend. But that bit when they told the old lady that her friend was dead was a total turnoff.
Funny.
So that's what I did immediately. Just so you know, thanks for listening, Nikki. All right.
Bye.
We lost one.
It was your fault, too, see?
What, the bill's dead?
Yeah.
A lot of people like the Bill's dead call.
Your fault.
I have an excuse. It happened a long time ago.
When you were mentally unstable.
That's right. I'm normal these days.
That what happened?
I'm very normal now.
I find that one of those really uncomfortable, funny things.
Should we replay the bit that made Nikki turn off our show forever?
Well, you're gonna chase other people away.
You think?
Yeah.
I don't even know where it is.
Other people are going to be very offended.
I love this bit, though. I love it.
Not to mention the New York listeners that are going to go, Jesus Christ.
Stop playing this bit.
Played it yesterday, for God's sake.
We haven't played this one a lot. It's the famous Bill's Dead call, Anthony.
It's quick and it's fun.
Old lady called the radio station. She thought she had her friend Bill on the line. Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Bill.
Who's this?
Pat.
Hi, Pat. How are you?
Now, this is the wrong Bill.
Well, Pat, I have some bad news.
What?
Bill died today.
Your kid? Oh, my God.
Yeah. Tragic.
Who's this?
He was in a car accident today.
Oh, no. Who is this?
John.
John?
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Oh, my God. I don't believe it.
Yeah.
I was just talking to him.
I know.
Where did it happen?
This afternoon.
Where?
On the highway.
Oh, God, love him.
Yeah, big pile up.
Well, be sure and give the kids my condolences.
Okay. Well, I gotta go.
All right, John.
All right.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
Wow. What's wrong with that?
Remember the question?
What?
Remember the question I asked you this morning?
No.
You call him up to God when he says, what are you going to say to him?
Oh, my God.
Should we introduce Annoying Laugh Anthony to Chicago and Philadelphia?
Annoying Laugh Anthony.
Who wants to be loved so bad
Let's
by
be nice now.
What do you bring us today?
Anthony.
What'd you bring today?
I brought four tickets for the Phillies Mets, July 28th.
Where are these seats?
They're at the same seats that you can't see the ball when it goes over into the air. I hope he doesn't want to sit there.
He offers us, well, no one wants to sit there. It has nothing to do with, you know.
Do you get a periscope with the tickets
so you can watch the ball? You can see the scoreboard.
A TV set? Something?
You can see the scoreboard.
The scoreboard, I can see that from home.
He's offering us these seats that are basically behind a pole, has a low ceiling.
It's so, way up top.
No, they're not.
At the stadium.
They're in the loge.
They're in the loge.
And but the overhang for the deck that's above you goes out so far in front of you, you feel like you're in da bunker.
Da bunker.
You feel like you're in an old World War II bunker. You're just encased in concrete. And if it's anything but a line drive is hit, you lose the ball.
You can't see the play.
A short little pop fly in the infield, you don't see it. It disappears because you're looking at concrete.
Right. They're not that bad.
Horrid seats. Awful.
They're horrible.
And I offered it to you before the contract. You said no. And then after the contract, you said definitely no.
These are box seats now. It has nothing to do with contracts. They're just horrible seats. I'd rather watch the game on TV.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what you're doing.
You can see the ball when it's up in the air. You can see.
You cannot see the ball when it's up on the air.
I can't. I've been to those seats.
It's row F, so you can see.
Kind of.
Row F.
Yes.
You're against the wall.
You're against the wall.
Row F is against the wall with the concrete overhang.
You know,
I'll take the tickets.
No, you're not taking the tickets.
What? I'll take the tickets.
You can give them to the listener.
I'll take the tickets.
No, you won't, because you'll rip them in front of me, and it's just standard procedure. You rip things, break things.
Boy, I'm too quick for you.
No, and he's going to make me, yeah. I don't want to hear
it. Sean, what's going on?
How are you guys doing today?
Pretty good.
I'm from Philly. I've been listening to your guys' show for the
two months. I know, and you hate us.
No.
All right, you hate us, so why are you listening, Sean?
Well,
I've
been giving you a chance.
All right.
I listened to you for the 2 months you've been on, or at least it seems that long anyway.
No, it's only been 11 days.
What's that?
It's only been 11 days, barely 2 weeks.
It seems like 2 months.
Yeah.
But I'd come to the conclusion I'd rather have to be forced to pleasure myself with a cheese grater while being forced to listen to NSYNC on a constant repeat than listen to you guys.
That's a funny one, Sean.
Sean, that's all you have?
That's all I can come up with. How long did you think about
what you were going to say?
Get the great cheese grater.
Actually, I just came up with a little bit ago. I was in the back doing some work.
The cheese grater bit.
That's horrible.
It sounded a little spontaneous, but it's written down on the phone thing, so you must have told the screener the same joke.
Yeah, well, here's my joke.
Here's my joke.
Well, he edited it for me slightly.
You're contributing.
Sean.
What's up?
Go listen to something else. We don't care.
Yeah.
I just want to let you know.
It's America. You can choose what to listen to.
If I didn't like something, I would never let them know I didn't like it. I just wouldn't even think about it anymore.
Sean, what would you rather hear?
I work in a restaurant doing prep work, so I'd rather be listening.
I knew you were going to do that. I knew you were going to do that.
Anthony, how was Aerosmith last night?
My seats were about as bad as Anthony's Mets tickets. But I had four really good seats that were like right up front, but I gave them to my family. And they saw Aerosmith. I was just there to kind of, I don't know who I saw.
Wait, you gave up your seats to your mom?
My mom,
and her husband.
My step dad, Sal, great guy. They're in their 60s.
Right.
Early 60s.
You went big doggy.
My sister.
You went big doggy style last night. You did, right? Limo and everything else.
I had big doggy style last night. What are you saying? What are you even saying?
I said you went big doggy.
Okay,
style.
Terrific.
What the hell does big?
Okay, terrific.
It's an expression.
No, it's not an expression.
I've never heard big doggy style.
Oh, dirty, call in. Tell me if I'm right.
No, one says big doggy style.
Oh, God.
Oh, God, forget it.
What the hell do you do?
Big doggy style.
Oh, it went big doggy style.
Wasn't that what Bob Crane was doing in some of his black and white 50s porno movies? It was big doggy style.
I think Annoying Laugh Anthony likes it in the doopa.
No, don't start.
In the doopa.
Don't go there.
Don't go there? Big doggy style?
Big doggy style.
I didn't say it. You went big doggy style. I did I?
I can't win.
So go ahead, Anthony.
Yes, I... I made sure they went in big doggy style, Opie. I set them up with the, you know, with a car and everything, a limo that took them in.
I'd punch him
whole night.
He's basically saying your mom went big doggy style.
Oh my God,
no,
is that what you were
that.
Saying?
Yes, you did.
No, I did not.
Then what the hell did you mean by big doggy style?
He went out like a big, you know, big dog. He went out. He brought it. They picked her up in a limo. Brought him. She had the best seats in the house. They probably went for dinner maybe or something to drink after that. It's big doggy style.
Hang
out
in the parking lot.
All right, they hung out in the parking lot. There was a lot of beer cans.
Doggy. I've never heard
Ant's
big
mom
doggy.
Did not go big doggy style.
I didn't say that.
There's nothing.
Don't start.
You never use big doggy style or doggy style in any way unless you're talking about doggy style.
Nobius.
Friggin' fag, you want to make out or something? Wrong! Try again, dumbass!
Wow.
What a stupid voice.
Jimmy, what's going on?
Yeah, Anthony, you're an idiot. It is big dog pit bull style. Do the world a favor. Don't talk slang, you effing idiot. I just wanted to say that, guys.
No. White or black?
What?
Am I right? You're
I'm
saying
white.
You're white, okay.
Yeah.
No, dirty calling.
No, it's he's saying it's big dog pit bull style.
Okay.
Not big doggy style.
And to other people saying, I think annoying ant means rolling like a big dog. Yeah, you know, you went like the big dog.
Big.
Not doggy style.
Big doggy style.
There's no doggy style. How do you go? The only way you're going doggy style is going doggy style.
All right.
Don't ever say ant's mom went big doggy style.
My God, what an insult.
I'm sorry.
Unbelievable.
Big doggy
style. Doggy style.
Shut up. Let's go to Tommy. Tommy, what's going on?
Faggot.
Shut up! Shut up!
He wanted to say, to get the giggling idiot out of the studio.
Well, you know that. As soon as I walk in, they want me out.
I listened to that for a while.
What?
Nothing.
What?
Nothing.
What happened?
Nothing.
What?
Just never stops.
What?
The abuse.
You do it to yourself.
I just made a comment. They didn't have to go nuts on me.
Dan from Hoboken. Limo Ann says, don't go there. I wish someone would say that to him before he decides to come into the studio. Now, that's funny, Dan.
Let's go to Randy. Randy, what's up? Randy.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, let me get those tickets. Those Mets tickets.
You want the Mets tickets?
Yeah, I've never been to a baseball game.
Well, after you sit in these seats,
they're still not
gone to a baseball game.
I'm serious. I'm a hockey fan. I've never been to a baseball game.
Sit in your garage with a TV. That's a better seat.
You have a better chance of seeing a puck than you do a baseball in those seats if you're a hockey fan.
Can I get those tickets, though?
Where are you?
I'm in Elmwood Park, in Bergen County, New Jersey.
All right, yeah, you could have the tickets.
Wait. He wants to watch Caddyshack tonight in with the van, so if somebody can get
Will you shut what the is he F say? Up? See, this is, anybody that isn't familiar with Anthony, you will hear him blurt stuff out that has nothing remotely resembling anything we're talking about at any given moment.
Because he gets really uncomfortable when there's a live mic in front of him, and he just feels like he has to do something.
So we're talking about anything. Yeah, we're talking about baseball.
Me, you
it's
know
like,
it.
Hey, Shea Stadium, you know, he's got those tickets out in real bad seats. Yeah, did you see the bubbles in the water cooler down the hall? What? You're like, what? the big sparking train locomotive break. Sparks flying off the rails.
We're talking about Met tickets, and now you're talking about Caddyshack.
Never mind.
Randy.
Yeah.
All right, hold on the line. We'll give you the tickets.
All right, thanks a lot.
Because no one around here wants them.
What? They're not that bad. What's the problem?
It's a chore.
Old Dirty.
Yo, what up, dog?
What up?
Here's Old Dirty. You told Old Dirty to call in about this going big doggy style. Old Dirty, what does that mean? He said you would know.
Well, checking me in the room, you know, blunting it up, and we heard Anthony say that you, Anthony, got it on doggy style in the back of the limousine.
Yeah, big doggy style.
Big doggy style.
Ed's getting it on big doggy style in the same limo with his mom and his stepdad.
So I'm implying, so I'm
you
here thinking
that. You stupid F.
Shut up.
That Anthony's doing doggy style in the back of the limo.
Yeah, it means nothing, right, Old Dirty?
No, man.
Oh, come on, Old Dirty. You know what I meant.
What you meant, man, Anthony? Come on, baby. Clear yourself.
All right. I will.
What you meant, man?
Big doggy. Went out. Limo, doggy. Restaurant, you know, good tickets.
Yeah. Limo, restaurant, Aerosmith show, and Ant got it in the dope
bar. That's Jim Barr.
Only means one thing.
Help. And Anthony was on his knees last night.
All right, old boy.
Yo, it's big dog style, man.
All right, I said doggy. I put the Y in.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, peace.
All right, baby, peace.
All right. There's another great name up for grabs on the opieanthony.com message.
Doggy style. Who's going to be big doggy style?
Tom, what's going on?
Yo, what's up, man?
Hey.
Yo, them seats that they got, man, they suck. You might as well sit on the couch and just toss a ball up and hit the ceiling.
You've been in those seats, right, at Chase Stadium?
They're terrible, man. And that guy that called from Philly,
yeah,
he was a real whack.
That's
he must
right.
have been a John DiBella fan.
No, we understand not everyone in Philly is going to get us. That's fine. We'll get enough people to make this work. I guarantee that.
Man, I've been listening for 11 days, man. And I'll tell you what, it's the best thing that happened for Philly.
Hey, thanks, Tom.
Yeah, no problem.
All right, bro.
I'd be late.
So why do you get the crappy seats to the baseball game?
Yeah, where do you get those?
Vital gives them to me.
Oh, they give them to me? Wow, they must really care about you as an employee.
They're good seats. They're not that bad. Oh,
is there some boxes right by the dugout with the little plaque that says Vital Limousine for the real employees?
You won't go.
And then there's like the other ones for you?
Wow, that's great. Yeah. I work my ass off for your company, and I'm never mentioned a nice thing about it. And I'm staring at a ceiling at a baseball game.
That's great.
No, really, thanks.
Any higher up, you count the rivets on L-1011s flying in.
So ungrateful, man.
Hey, Chris.
If I could, by facto, divert to a movie at this point.
Yes. Yeah.
Limo Anthony is Tom Hanks in Philadelphia.
All right. Yeah, let's go back to the Aerosmith show.
Alex,
thank you, Ben.
Alex from Staten Island, crappy Mets tickets, $75. Aerosmith tickets, $150. Hitting it big doggy style with your mom, priceless.
Effing priceless.
Big doggy style.
Great. Anyway, yeah, big doggy style.
Paulie has a really good question, and I do want to answer this. Paulie, go ahead.
Yeah, I want to know why that limo guy gets to sit in there every day. Not every day, just every once in a while.
Very rare occasions.
And I'll tell you, I'll answer this question because I like to be annoyed.
Go ahead.
It's something that's twisted inside me. I like being annoyed.
Yeah, some people like just being annoyed.
I really like being annoyed, and you do the best effing job.
Well, you're a nasty bastard. You know how you are.
Look how annoying this is.
You know, he's a one annoying son of a bitch. Shut up and hang up the phone.
Oh, wow.
Shut up, you limo moron.
You're gaining fans with that.
I'm not even fighting with them. It's you.
You drive a limo. What makes you get to sit up there? I work in a sewage treatment plant. Should I come up there and get to sit in there? And I work with crap all day. What do you do?
No. I sit in a...
Paulie, you can come up here.
I want to come in, man. I want to come in and sit next to this guy.
Yeah, let's get the crap guy. Paulie, hold on the line. We'll get you in here.
All right.
All right.
We want crap guy.
We want crap guy. We want crap guy.
Well, he's going to sit near you.
What other presents did you bring us today?
That's it.
That's it, huh?
No champagne?
The van will be downstairs at 7 o'clock.
What van?
The van that's bringing you to Mulcahy's tonight.
You own a limo company. What happened to the limo?
It's prom night. It's the busiest prom night of the year.
Oh. The van? You do it to yourself.
I know what
the deal is. He has a limo company. He wants to get the name out there, get the listeners calling his business to get a limo. So you would think if you were helping us out by, you know, transporting the whole show to our gig tonight, that you would get a limo. So tomorrow on the radio, we would go, wow, Anthony, you know?
Never.
He's an effing tool, but man, his limo was great. His driver was great.
He's so nasty. You know what? Let me tell you something.
Is there champagne chilling in the ashtray?
Four cases. Remember?
Champagne. I wish it was champagne. Probably Schlitz.
Rianiti on ice.
He called me and said to get you guys the Mulcahy's. It didn't matter what I gave you guys.
No, a town car,
a limo, a van. It didn't matter.
I can't wait for tomorrow's show. We're going to talk all about your bus.
Look like the clamp. It's heading into Beverly Hills. You could sit on the rocking chair tied to the boxes in the back, Opie.
A rickshaw.
I'm pulling as fast as I can. Shut up.
I was talking to you about this off the air.
Okay.
You don't know how to run your business.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Here's a perfect example. You own a limo company.
Okay.
And you're going to do us a favor, obviously, right?
Fine.
So why are you giving us a bus? You want us to talk about your bus all day? Or the fine limo that you must have in that fleet of three?
It's a fleet of three. What's the problem? When I started, there was a fleet of none.
So what? You got two limos and a bus, right?
Yes.
And we get the bus.
Yes.
Okay. We'll talk all about the fine bus tomorrow.
But you like the bus. You've been in the bus already. It's got the TV, the VCR, the CD player, and it's got nice seats. Not.
It's a bumpy ride.
You don't even plug the company.
I thought I told you to shut up.
You're right.
Anthony, how was the Aerosmith show?
Well, like I said, I had tickets pretty far away, but the family... my mother, big Aerosmith fan. You know, she's like 62 years old. Really into Aerosmith. So I figured, hey, you let her have the good seats right up front with my sister and her husband, Johnny, and Sal. Sal acts a little more his age than my mom does. Sal didn't even have a clue who Aerosmith was. So I'm sitting up top looking down at the seats they have.
You had the back row, right?
Dude, my back against cement. That's why I was like, well, at least if when I stand up, I don't have to worry about some tool behind me going sit down or something. I can lean against the wall.
Mm-hmm.
Not like I'm just standing the whole time. That's how far back I was.
Look at you making lemonade out of lemons.
That's right. And I had to sit. You know who's happening next to me? Remember the winner from yesterday who wowed us and got the tickets?
The Aerosmith tickets?
Yeah, her and her boyfriend right next to us.
We gave her bad tickets?
Oh, yeah. And I could tell... I could tell she wanted to, like, complain maybe. Because I would. I'd be like, you win tickets. You expect to get some good tickets. But she couldn't say anything because I was up there. How the hell could she expect to get better tickets? I was up there. So I'm looking down, and I'm just like, oh, my God. They're sound checking. And you're hearing, check, one, two, check, check, check. I'm like, uh-oh. Sal's head is going to explode. He's not used to this. He's used to going to... like Westbury Music Fair in the round to see Kenny Rogers or something, you know? Not used to full-blown rock show. So I sit there, and Aerosmith comes out. I'm just like, oh, my God. Oh, no. And they're loud, really loud. I'm looking down, my mother and sister dancing, having a great time. Johnny's having a great time. Sal's just sitting there. I see his gray hair in the seat, just sitting there. And they'd go into some songs like... you know, Sweet Emotion. I'm like, he's got to know that one, you know. He's going back a few years. No,
nothing,
not a clue.
Nothing.
Show gets done. We meet back at the car in the parking lot. Now he's yelling because his ears are blown out. His ears are blown out. I hear him coming because I left before the encore to get back to the car so I could get a few drinks before my drunk family drinks everything. So I went back to the car, me and my girlfriend, early, and I hear them coming. Row, where's the limo, Row? It's from Baltimore. The accent's killer. Row, where's the car, Row? And my mother's like, Sal, would you shut up? You're yelling. You're yelling. This is people walking away from an Aerosmith show. Remember the old days, I guess? People that used to go to Aerosmith? You're smoking pot. You got your denim jacket on. You're probably 22 at the oldest. Here's two people in their early 60s. Row! I can't find the car. I gotta pee. I gotta pee. They won't let me back in without my ticket, Row. The show's over, Sal. They're not gonna let you back in. Gets it back in the car. Where's the wine, Row? Like, and my mother's just, thank you so much. I had a great time. The tickets are great. We're right up front. Sal's like, I didn't know one song. Okay, I knew the one from Armageddon. That was it. Like, he was thrilled. Oh, this is who this is. He goes, I thought we were seeing Air Supply. What?
He didn't say that.
Yeah,
he?
Yeah. Aerosmith, I thought it was Air Supply, Row. I've been dying.
And he had a nice limo?
Oh, yeah. Oh, it was a beautiful limo.
Yeah, who gave you the limo?
Nice big stretch. Oh.
Who gave the limo?
Don't even...
Vital...
Come on.
You see? Anthony, your sister's on the line. Dawn.
Yeah. Dawn.
Hey.
How you doing?
Good. How you doing?
Did you have fun last night?
You know, it was so fun going big doggy style.
Isn't
really
it great? As per Anthony, annoying Anthony, you were going big doggy style.
Did
with
Aunt
me.
Sister go big doggy style too, along with
Sorry,
the Aunt's
Ro.
Mom and Aunt's stepfather?
Ro,
we were all going big doggy style in the limo.
How was the rest of the ride back with Sal?
Oh, it was cool. We stopped off at a bar and, you know.
Of course. They ran out of booze in the limo?
We drank everything in the limo.
My
so we
family
had to stop.
Drunks.
I got
yeah.
World record holders. I got audio of you guys driving away from the concert.
Oh, you do? Oh,
yes.
Let's listen. On the bus.
Oh,
that the bus pulling away?
The bus pulling away.
Did you have a good time, Ro?
Huh?
You are... I'm getting too annoyed.
I didn't hear
We're not talking to Ant's mom,
it's
Ro.
It's my sister, Dawn.
Oh, you sorry, Dawn.
Idiot.
I'm at Limo, Anthony.
Oh, did you hear about this?
Dawn, I'm sorry about... Wait a minute.
Did you want to go big doggy style with Ant's sister?
Dawn.
Yeah.
Anthony talking, Dawn, tell everybody listening exactly what happened when you met Annoying Laugh Anthony. Tell us where it was and what happened.
It was really simple. We were down at a bar in Freeport. It was Memorial Day weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And we were talking to some guys, and one of my friends says, oh, you know, come on over here because somebody mentioned your show. And they're like, this is Anthony's sister, Dawn. So Anthony comes over, and he's like, I effing hate those guys.
And then what?
And he turns around and walks away.
And walked away from her. She goes, hi, I'm Dawn. You know, introduced herself. You went, I effing hate those guys, and turned and walked away from my sister. Dissed my sister.
Yeah.
Anthony, comment?
Totally true.
And why was that?
I was drunk out of my brain. I was having a bad fight, and I apologize to you. Very much so. Because you were being very nice to me, and I'm sorry. Wait a minute. My friends told you I was cool. I was having a bad day, and I apologize about that. Really do.
They were trying to convince me.
Come on.
It wasn't working.
Please, Dawn, I'm sorry.
Why would you say such a thing?
Because I was having a bad day, and it just didn't even click. It was like nine drinks late.
We treat you with nothing but respect.
You hate me.
Yeah.
You hate me, Dawn. I'm sorry.
Why would you say that?
I was having a bad day.
What put you over the edge where you would say such a horrible thing about your pals?
I was having a bad day.
Was it the darts we threw at your back?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
The darts?
Put it to you this way. The darts at my back... My mother found out in Virginia. My girlfriend Jessica didn't talk to me for 3 days.
Did she find out big doggy style? Yeah. Your mom?
And it was a bad situation. I am sorry, Dawn, if you accept my apology. I'm sorry.
Well, I was completely dumbfounded, Anthony. I couldn't figure out.
Why
he's being so nasty.
And I did tell your brother to apologize to you, but did he relay the message to you?
Thanks to your life, scumbag.
I apologize. I'm sorry.
See, he was nasty.
Yeah, I'll accept that apology. But now, what about with my mother and big doggy style?
No.
You got more apologizing to do.
No, come on now.
Apologize. Yeah.
Waddle doodle.
Gonna call him Grease Man.
Yeah, big doggy style.
Dawn, those guys said you guys were great. I'm sorry about that. They had a good time with you guys.
I don't know. Okay. I can't accept his apology.
Come on, Opie.
If we could throw two more darts at
you. No, goodbye.
Two darts.
No.
Just two darts.
No. Two darts. No.
I think that's the only way that it's going to be made better.
One dart. One dart.
No.
Everything
darts.
Forgiven.
No darts.
One dart.
No darts.
Oh, ooh.
You're putting your foot down now?
No, come on.
He's putting his foot down, Anthony.
Yes.
Who? You told us.
One dart.
I'm not.
Friggin' lawn dart to the brainstem. One dart.
We'll play doggy style with one lawn dart.
Big doggy style.
Big doggy style with one lawn dart.
You bend over.
Let's see who can hit the bullseye.
And you know who it's going to be. You, probably. Throwing it from over there. You know what you did to me? I had injuries on my arm and in my backside.
Shut up, Demi.
I'm gay.
Oh, God.
You had injuries from a dart.
You saw it. It was bleeding.
You are very ignorant. You are even more stupid than I first computed.
And we should explain to Philadelphia and Chicago.
Yeah.
The dart incident. Because there's some bad blood because of the dart incident. You know how many plugs you got for that?
Yeah, but it's just caused a lot of problems, man.
Why?
Why? I was getting death threats from people. People like, you effing tool. How could you let them throw darts?
That had nothing to do with the darts.
Oh,
right.
Please. Nobody ever emailed me once during
the
last
Have you ever
minute.
Heard yourself on the radio?
Yeah.
You conjure up this whole image that people just want to hate.
I think so.
Has nothing to do with the darts. Matter of fact, your mouth was pretty much shut through that bit.
Hey, listen, guys, I can't listen anymore. It's distracting my driving.
All right, Dawn.
And you need it.
All right, Dawn.
We used to call her
Crash.
Bye.
Have fun tonight, guys.
All right.
Look, I got a new car. Here's Dawn. Every friggin' new car she gets. Look, I got a new car. Oops, what happened? Hey, the light was blue. I went because the light was blue. She said that once.
Yeah.
She got in an accident at an intersection. She goes, it wasn't my fault. The light was blue.
Blue? Dawny.
They had a great time, though, but Sal, like I said, was looking for Air Supply. Air Supply, Aerosmith, just a tad different.
That's funny. Now, explain the dart thing really fast for Chicago and Philly.
Well, Anthony loves plugging his limo service.
Which I have not done today once
of
yet.
Of course not. He loves plugging it, and we never let him. Never let him. So we decided one day we'd let him get how many plugs in? Ten? Ten plugs!
It depended on how many times we hit him in the back with the darts.
Yeah.
If it stuck, he got, what, three plugs per?
Five
plugs for each dart that stuck in your back.
So he turned his back, we took darts, and threw them into his back.
The worst decision.
Couple stuck.
Do we have a taste of that audio that we can maybe play after break? We don't have to play the whole bit because it's long. But
I just want to hear one where it really hit him good.
Yeah, just a taste of that.
Sure.
All right.
Right now.
Oh, look, we got a dart.
Get away from me.
And come on, we'll just lock
it. Get away
right.
from me. No.
Oh, my God. Rick just made like he was throwing at me. He's passed out.
Hey, man, give me the dart. I'll do it.
That's great.
I will never speak to you again. Here's your choice.
God, you made this so easy. You know, line 9 has a great point.
All right, hold on.
Oscar.
Hey, what's up, boys?
Hey.
Hey, I got a question for you, human target.
Yeah.
Who are you taking to the prom? It's almost July. You taking special ed kids, retards, what?
Aren't, isn't prom season over?
No, the 25th, Monday, it's over. It's the last
You're
day.
Such a liar.
I'm serious.
Anything to get a plug, right?
He's going on their prom. Yeah, it does seem a little late for a prom, but...
Stop being cheap.
Proms
give them
like
a limo.
In May and maybe early June. It's you know, the 21st.
No,
the
25th ends the last one. Come on, would you stop? He's aiming a dart. He's just sitting here ready to throw a dart at me.
Oh, my God, Opie's got the dart now. That's bad.
What?
Opie's thrown things at people that deserved nothing but the best treatment. Ben, many times, is in the way of Opie's wrath when a cart goes flying into something.
Let's play a game. Let's play a game. This is it.
Shall we play a game?
Go ahead.
I'll give you 2 seconds to run.
Oh, no. The second his ass leaves the chair, he has 2 seconds, and then you throw. How long is the count?
And if I miss you, you can plug your limo.
Oh, no.
Why? You're not throwing darts at me.
You could, like...
You're not throwing darts at me.
Anthony, do you think you could get off that chair and through that door in 2 seconds?
If he does, I swear to Christ, I'll never speak to him.
He's getting up.
Either way.
Now he wants to run because he knows you have the dart.
2 seconds.
Oh, no. He's going to do it.
Vital transportation. What?
He cuts him off.
Come on.
Never plug.
Come on. As soon as you drop those headphones, you got 2 seconds.
Oh, now it's dropped the headphones?
Well, that'll start the count.
Screw it. Just throw it.
All right. The headphones are... He wheeled over by the door.
The door's locked! Come on. No more.
Now that would have been
Please.
Hysterical.
I'll play fair. Go.
No, I don't want to play fair. It's always this. It comes down to this. You ridicule me. I'm done.
You're never done.
Yeah, I'll be done.
You like the attention. Now, take the headphones
I really don't want
more,
the attention.
More attention for you.
I don't want the attention. No, the door
My
is locked.
My heart is pounding. Let's go.
You throw it at me.
Unlock the door. 2 seconds. The door's
open. 2 seconds for when the door opens.
Oh my God. It's locked!
Look at it. He's panicking.
He locked the door, and he's freaking out now. He's sweating.
Hope you don't.
Just open the door and go. You got 2 seconds. You go anywhere.
Let me get my tickets and let me get my phone because you ain't letting me back in. I know this.
Run! All right, lock the door.
Look at him run.
Lock the door.
Did you see him run?
I just wanted to get him out of the studio.
Did you see
he
him
fell
run?
Oh,
loser.
Oh, my God.
His annoying laugh.
Big doggy style.
He's gonna cry.
All right, keep him out of here. Scott, what's up?
Hey, Opie and Anthony.
Yeah, man.
How you guys doing?
Pretty good.
Hey, I live in the Lehigh Valley, and they have nothing but crap on the radio out here.
Yeah.
So I have to tune in to WYSP out of Philadelphia.
Right on.
I gotta tell you, you guys are hilarious.
You having fun?
It's the best thing that's ever happened to the radio station, I'll tell you.
It's just us screwing off.
Yeah,
we think it's fun.
It's freaking hilarious. That bit you did on Bill Clinton and cops.
Oh, we love that one, yeah.
I was in tears. That was freaking hilarious.
Scott, thanks, man. We appreciate the positive feedback coming from Philly already, so thank you.
All right,
Scott.
Later.
All right.
What is he, Amish? He lives out there?
No, we do have...
Yep. I like it.
We do have to get like 20 seconds of audio of us hitting Anthony with the darts because it's too good. But we won't play the whole bit because New York is like going, oh, no, I've heard that.
Yeah.
But we got to play for Philly and Chicago.
The thing is, though, I think him thinking he was about to get hit with a dart has done more damage to him.
Very good. That's what it was all about.
He's sitting out there like...
He was sweating.
Trembling.
It's like that feeling when somebody puts a rubber band on their finger and pulls it back and points it at you, and you got that feeling. He had that the whole time he was sitting down. You mind-effed him. You mind-effed him. I effed you.
And Mario, I mind-effed him.
Mario Cantone is outside.
Oh, really? Bob, what's up?
Hey, how you guys doing?
Hey.
I haven't been listening to you guys that long, but... since I've been listening, I think you guys are great.
Oh, thanks, Bob.
Listen, about this guy, Anthony.
Yeah.
He lets you throw darts at him?
Yeah.
Yeah, we threw darts at
him. If you stick through the break, we'll play some audio where we're throwing darts at his back so he could plug his limo company, yes.
That's why he lets you do it, so he could plug his company?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
What a freaking moron that guy is.
New listener already gets it.
Yeah, I mean, I
don't
understand.
Take long.
Somebody lets you throw sharp objects at them.
Yeah.
It just doesn't make any sense to me.
We'll play the audio next, all right, Bob?
All right, great.
Thank you.
Talk to you later.
Also, Anthony, a quick tease. Listen to this.
A quaint apartment in Greenwich Village, $500. A 15-minute subway ride from work to your quaint apartment, $1.50. A rooftop view of the entire New York City skyline, free. Getting to live with a 60-year-old pedophile? Absolutely f***ing priceless. Some things Stinky can buy. For everything else, there's lifelong therapy. Brought to you by the National Psychotherapy Association and the makers of fine antipsychotic medication.
That's the tease. We checked out Stinky's apartment last night.
Oh!
He lives with the pedophile. We all got a view of Stinky's life when he's not at the radio station. Holy S.
These palatial digs are Stinky's.
We have to do this now?
Oh, all right.
We have a pair of VIP seats and limo transportation to the WWF King of the Ring at the Continental Arena this Sunday. You'll also receive tickets to a meet-and-greet brunch with some of the WWF superstars. Who is providing the limo?
That would be Victory.
Oh. Victory Limousine.
Oh.
That would be the other limo company that advertises with our show.
That's like eating a Whopper in front of Ronald McDonald right there. Look
at him walk down the
hall. Look at him. He's all pissed off now.
Look at him. He's crying. Get him back here. He's leaving crying.
We're some sick ass, I'm telling you right now.
So pissed. Call your local cable provider to order the WWF King of the Ring. Limo transportation is courtesy of Victory Limousine, 631-842-8679. Hey, Mario, we'll talk to you next.
Mario.
But if you want this WWF thing with the limo and everything, random caller right now, 877-692-1027. Anthony, I want to play... Oh, man, we're so late. I'll do it next.
Right.
Remember the caulk bit?
Cock.
C-A-U-L-K.
Of course.
We'll have to do that as part of the next break. Stay there.
Daddy, touch my dirty place.
This is what we do every day. We just get teenage girls naked.
Anthony.
What are we going to do next, though? Okay. Go to schoolyards and sell ecstasy?
Opie and Anthony Show. 102.7 WNEW is the sports guys at 5 a.m. The radio chick at 9. Ron and Fez at noon. Opie and Anthony at 3. Don and Mike at 7. It's the radio chick.
Say hi to Tracy Morgan.
Yeah, when I was working over at SNM, after every show, we showered together like I'm Starship Troopers. You know what I'm saying?
Telling everybody!
Well, let's just say that, like the ladies, man, he's also a Jedi Master of the Wang. You know what I'm saying? And his new name is Obi-Wan Kenobi. You know what I'm saying? All right, then. The ladies, man, they said the word Wang enough for one day.
The Radio Chick, weekdays 9 to noon, 1027 WNEW.
How hard would you train? How much pain would you endure? How far would you go to fulfill your dream? It's WWF Tough Enough! A new reality-based television series premiering tonight at 10 p.m. on MTV. 13 men and women given the chance to fulfill a dream and become a WWF superstar. They'll live together, train together, live big doggy style together, suffer together. But in the end, it's one man and one woman who walk away with a guaranteed WWF contract.
This series kicks off tonight with a one-hour casting special. More than 5,000 hopefuls submitted videotape entries. Only 230 were invited to tryouts at WWF. The one-hour special documents these exclusive auditions and led to the selection of the 13 competitors. The series continues Thursday night, 10 p.m., with 12 half-hour episodes, beginning June 28th on MTV. WWF Tough Enough, 10 p.m., 9 Eastern on MTV.
Catch the best of Opie and Anthony. Saturdays, 11 to 3, 1027 WNEW.
And we're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. Give us a call, toll free, 877-692-1027. Or you could reach us through the instant feedback, Anthony.
Yes.
On WNEW.com. And, yeah, that's a good way to do it, right?
Sure, we read them all.
Yes, we do, and we try to get some of that stuff on the air as well. Mm. But we got to say hi to Mario Cantone in the studio.
I'm back with my boys and proud of it.
Mario Cantone.
Back with the boys. Hello, boys. Congratulations on your big, big success. Contracts, security, everything.
Thank you, Mario.
It's really great.
Mario Cantone, of course, beloved host of the Steam Pipe Alley for many years ago.
Why must my past haunt me? Why? Didn't you do Bunghole Alley? Wasn't that you on Stovetop Stuffing? Why? I live in the projects and they still attack me every day. What happened to your kid show? Aren't you doing anything anymore? How come I don't see you on TV anymore?
You're on Sex in the City.
You bet your ass I was. Now get out of my way. Yes, yes, I was. I love how you, like, defend me.
Yes.
Even when I'm in character, berating myself, you come to my defense. Yeah, I
see, the difference between you and Annoying Laugh Anthony, we like you.
Of course, yeah. I know you do.
Oh, jeez, you got to keep pounding
that
Anthony.
You know what?
He's outside the studio. He hasn't left.
Sulking.
People
there
think,
he is. What? I like you, too.
Oh,
just
Anthony.
In a different way. All right.
Oh,
he just needs to be loved. Man.
Get your cars out. Drive them around. So, you know, I don't know what to do anyway. No, you, all right.
Sex
so,
in the City.
Sex in the City. That's what I'm doing. Yeah, I was on the season premiere, and I'm doing one more in a few more weeks. Sweet Sex in the City, you guys. I'm so happy. It's made me really famous.
What's your character about on that?
Well, I play Anthony Marantino, who actually, I did one episode last year. I was Kristen Davis's, who plays Charlotte's wedding consultant or stylist. And then this year, she tried to fix me up with the first episode was they tried to fix me up with this guy that was.
You're playing a gay guy on Sex
and
the City?
A gay.
Is that a stretch?
You're playing a gay.
I love this. You're playing. A gay.
You're playing a gay.
Yeah, I'm gay. Did you see that? Like, I can say the word fag because I'm a homosexual.
Right.
Fag. Chitty, chitty, fag, fag. Chitty, chitty, that was so funny last night.
Friggin' fag, you want to make out or something?
Was that great?
That was the best. They didn't blame you. Gee, the little thing you learned about you. You friggin' fag, you want to make out or something?
So you play a gay guy.
I'm playing a gay. I thought I was just saying that. Yeah, I'm playing a gay guy.
A gay.
Yeah, and the next...
Was it a stretch?
Yeah, it was a big stretch, I'll tell you that. Bend over, we're going to give you some range.
Why aren't you... Well, you should have gotten on Queer as Folk on Showtime.
You want to know what? That is the car crash television show of the second.
Is it? Have you watched it?
Oh, I haven't missed an episode. It's so ridiculous that you can. And then, like, I love how all the guys are like, you know, everybody's like on talk shows talking about their girl. I do not want to hear you talking about your girlfriends when you're playing a gay on Showtime. Yeah, it was just a thing in the Post today. Believe it or not, these five hairdressers are hunky, hot, and heterosexual. How do you know they're not getting their thing sucked someday by the shampooist? Yeah. You don't know that. You don't know the dark secrets that people carry. They carry them. They carry them until eventually they become a big boil on their head and they pop and the pus drips all over them and kills them. That's what happens when you repress. Repression is bad. I'm a guy.
You know, you pass by that show there, Queer as Folk, because I just passed by it, Mario.
I tell you, like, oh, look, it's House Boss S. He's getting bad. There's a lot of plowage on that show.
Every time I pass by it, there's just hardcore man-on-man sex going on that show.
And a lot of people think I'm... Some people know they know me from somewhere, but they'll go, aren't you that guy on Talk Soup? Oh, aren't you that guy on Queer as Folk? No! That's Hal Sparks! Thank you very much. I'm not on Queer as Sheep.
Wait, Jackie has a question. This is pretty funny. Jackie, what's up?
Is that a man or a woman on the air?
Oh, shut up.
You shut up. You're sitting on the street.
It's Judy Garland, Jackie. It's Judy Garland.
Back from the dead. And Liza is over here. And Lorna and Joey and Sid Luff stole my money. I want my money, Sid.
I loved her drunken rambles.
Oh, it's... I have the tape.
Great. Do you have the tape?
It's devastating. Another car crash.
We're supposed to play it on the air.
Car crash.
It's devastating. Yeah. I don't know if you want to play it on the air. It's too much.
But Reese made her smart. Come across
I love her. But the stuff she was saying, a lot of it was true. She's like, David Beagleman and Freddie Fields, my agents, stole my money and Sid Luff gambled it at the my eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. Lorna, bring me those pills. I need my vitamins. What's the next song? Mark Lindsay, ladies and gentlemen.
I've heard pieces of those tapes, and it's just brutal.
And it's the first thing she says. She's got this. She's got the recording. She's like, now let me see if I can work this black Nazi box. I don't know. Hello? I'm going to shut it off now and see if it's working. Click. And then you go back and say, well, it was working. Oh, my God. They're all going to laugh at you. It's like Carrie. They're all going to laugh at you. We're very sorry, Cassie. It's Carrie. You can trust me, Carrie. You know me, Carrie. You can trust me. They're all going to laugh at you.
I see your dirty pillows.
They're breasts, Mama.
And your stepdad's on the line.
What is he doing?
We've been making him hold. Hey, Sal.
Down.
Yeah.
Turn your radio down.
Turn your radio down, bro.
Bro.
I got to tell you, Steve, my ex-boss was listening to you guys you were talking about last night.
Yeah.
I got to tell you, I enjoyed myself so much.
You liked Aerosmith?
Even though my ears are still ringing,
I decided
if you can get me Metallica tickets, that's where I want to go.
You want to go see Metallica? Nice.
Metallica? Rose said it was Metallica, yes. That's what I want to see.
Download it off of Napster.
What?
Yeah, see what?
Get some Metallica from Napster.
He went last night, Mario. I took him, Sal, my mother, sister, and brother-in-law to see Aerosmith. And they were right up front, and Sal gets out of the show. He's yelling because his ears are... Look at him. His ears are ringing. He's like, Row, where's the limo, Row? He's just yelling because his ears are shot. He's like, I didn't know Aerosmith. I thought we were seeing Air Supply, which is a big difference.
That's a big difference.
So your ears are still ringing, Sal?
Yeah, they haven't stopped, but I want to go again. Just give them a few days. If we can get those Metallica tickets, I'm ready to go.
You just said Metallica. He left them off.
Like a real Metallica fan. Go see Metallica.
Yeah, that's
it. All right, Sal, we'll get you some tickets. You want to go see Korn?
Oh, yeah, them too. Anybody that's good rock.
Sal, get into the pit. Start moshing.
You want to talk to your mom real fast?
Yeah, where's Mommy?
Where's Ro?
Mommy, you're on the air. Come here.
Where's Ro?
Ro!
And I definitely want to stand up again for 2-3 hours. That's good. Hold on.
He thought it was like Westbury, Kenny Rogers at Westbury, where everyone sits. Sal had to stand. How's Sal's ears, Mom?
What? Oh, he can hear, sort of.
Yeah.
It'll take him a few more days, I think.
Are you wearing your Aerosmith shirt that you bought at the show last night?
It's me like a dress. I love it. I went to the gym in that, you know.
It's Mom
Rocks. A few looks from a few of the women. What do you know?
You had a good time, though?
I had a great time.
Good seats?
Couldn't see Steven Tyler? Please. It was...
She was
phenomenal.
In a fun robe.
Yeah.
Just about, right?
She was going right up to the rail and taking pictures of Steven Tyler.
I didn't care who was chasing me away.
And she had to keep saying, you know, he's no kid anymore, but
no,
he looks great.
Yeah, he does.
He looks good, though.
He looks great, though.
He does.
Mom, you remember Mario Cantone from Steampipe Alley?
No.
Remember I used to watch Steam Pipe Alley?
Yeah.
And he would do all those wacky bits and stuff.
Oh, that's the person who's on now?
Yeah.
Right now, Mommy.
Oh, I thought it was a woman.
No.
Oh, Jesus.
I get that from the operators, too. Man, I'm sorry, I don't have that number.
Oh, I didn't know that.
No, it's all right. You know, I'm every woman.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
If you say so.
Mommy!
Mommy, he does Mommy Dearest.
Yeah, but I do Mommy.
Oh, God.
Christina!
Christina, I told you! One of these wire hangers doing in the closet!
Oh, no, Joan Crawford.
Yeah. But that's Faye Dunaway as Joan Crawford.
Right.
The real Joan Crawford.
The real Joan Crawford.
The real Joan Crawford sounded like this. I'd like my set at 58 degrees, otherwise I don't go on the set. And when I leave, I turn to the crew and I say, bless you.
Oh, God.
That's the real Joan Crawford, but no one gets it because no one knows what she really sounded like.
Right. They all know from Mommy Dearest.
You know, they all know from Mommy Dearest and Faye Dunaway.
Okay. Mm. I love you, Mommy Dearest.
I love you, too.
I'll talk to you later.
Okay, bye.
Bye, Ro.
Bye.
How cute is Ro? Her name is Rosalie?
Rosemary.
Rosemary.
Mario.
Rose.
The coolest mom right there.
Yeah.
She's very cute.
She's like, she works out. She's 62 years old. She works out every day to the point where, you know, she's in better shape than I could ever dream of being in. And she's like really fit. She's strong, too. She's like smacking the back of the head at the table and go, ow!
She's Italian, huh?
Oh, yeah.
It's amazing because, you know, the Italian women in my mother's generation, they did not work out. You know, they were staring at sauce.
The big mamarels.
The mamarella.
Fat ass and big boobs that during the holidays, they'd rest them on the table.
They would.
And their plate would have to be a good 2 feet away from them because it was pure boob.
Please. They could knead the gnocchi with those breasts. but my sister, Marion, is in her 50s, and she looks incredible. And she goes to the gym like 5 times a week. She looks unbelievable.
Yeah, the gym rats now.
They're unbelievable.
It's amazing.
Well, the gym's good. You know, it's a good thing.
And she's dancing around at Aerosmith last night.
She's rocking. Rock and roll.
Jesus Christ, it's my mother.
And we definitely have to take a break to catch up.
Yeah, we got
to
catch up.
Mario from Massachusetts, so this bit will make him laugh pretty hard. How do you say C-A-U-L-K in Massachusetts?
Chuck! Quack!
Quack! Exactly.
Block! Dollar Tommy Quack! Oh, get the quack out of the wine bottle! Take your quack out of the wine bottle! You're plugging up the wine bottle with your quack! It's a quack! It's your quack! Get the quack! Grow.
That's right. Don't dump out. That's how they say it.
They do.
Juices.
That's cork.
That's quartz.
Cork.
Cock.
Cock.
So
it used to happen all the time.
I was like, what?
When I was living up there, my God. Oh, Jesus.
Anthony, could you please get the cork out of the bottle? Bobby, stop doing that crack in the back room and come out here and serve the customers. My cousin Gogo. Bobby, I know you spoke of that crack. She's run out of breath at the end of every sentence. You're smoking crack in the bathroom. You better get back out here and serve the customers. I can't do it alone. And I cannot stand that disgusting smell of crack anymore. Where's your wife, Lisa? Lisa? Let me tell you something. I held a shower for Lisa because she wanted a shower at the Town Line Lynn, and I gave her a shower. Now, Connie had a shower for her daughter, and let me tell you something. She wanted all the bridesmaids to pitch in. I said, these girls have little jobs. They can't pitch in. She's got a lot of nerve to have them pitch in. I said, Connie, these girls have little jobs. They can't pitch in. I can't breathe anymore. Get me my oxygen tank.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Oh, screw the bit.
Little jobs.
We don't need to play it then. You want to play the call?
I just did it.
You want to, right? All right, play it.
Play it.
All right.
Throw it before.
We did a prank call, we called it, I don't know.
I think it was one of those big home centers.
Oh, yes.
Just say that. One of those big name home centers.
Right, and this lady is from Massachusetts, and she was looking for C-A-U-L-K.
And she
Calk.
Right. What you, said, what you used to plug your, you know, the windows up or your bathtub or something. Caulk.
Caulk.
Right.
Right. By the way, Mario Cantone playing Caroline's tonight.
Yep.
Tonight. Saturday, Sunday, and Monday.
Yes.
He's not playing Friday.
No Friday because it's a Sabbath.
All right. Let's play C-A-U-O-K here. And we'll be back with Mario Cantone.
Hello, miss. I'm an elderly woman. I just moved here from Boston, Massachusetts. And I have a leaky bathtub.
Uh-huh.
I believe I need caulk to fill in the hole.
You need, pardon me?
I need caulk.
Okay, please hold.
Thank you for holding. We will be with you shortly.
Hello?
Yes, I'm in desperate need of caulk. The old caulk just ain't working anymore.
Okay. Over in the paint department, they have GE silicone they got for that.
Is that good caulk?
Sure is.
And that works good in the bathtub?
Sure does.
Could I speak to someone in the paint department?
Sure, hold on 1 second. You can call back.
Hello, miss. I need caulk.
You need cork?
No, I need caulk. If I needed caulk, I would have said caulk.
Clark.
Does he supply the caulk?
Can you spell this for me?
C-A-U-L-K. Caulk.
Please hold.
Hello?
Paint department.
Hi, I need caulk.
Huh?
I need caulk.
Clark?
Caulk.
Yeah?
I need caulk, because I own a house now, and all the caulk in my house is all dried up.
Okay.
I need some brand new caulk. You carry caulk?
You need caulk?
Yes, I need caulk for my bathtub.
What kind? Just, what kind of color are you looking for?
I don't really care. I like white caulk, but, I'll take any color. The caulk that's in my house is all dried and cracked. And it's leaky caulk. I need new caulk.
All right. Well, we got all sorts of shapes and varieties here of caulk for you, you know.
All kinds of shapes of caulk?
Oh, yeah. We even have one that's about 2 feet long.
Really, darling?
Yeah, a tube, yeah.
Well, that's a lot of caulk.
Yeah.
I probably could use that much.
What yeah, a lot of people could.
Thank you, sir. You've been very kind.
Also, we have some special guns to attach to the caulk, you know. Get a little more width there.
Caulk gun?
Yep.
Oh, that sounds very exciting. I'll have to come down.
All right, we got plenty for you.
Thank you very much.
And if you
much.
Don't see anything on the shelf you like, some of our employees have their own that they can give to you.
Their own special brands of caulk?
Oh, yeah.
That's wonderful, darling.
We do everything for you here.
Thank you very much, son.
We'll even send someone over to your house sometimes to help you use it.
To help me install the caulk?
Yep, they'll install it for you real nice.
Somebody could help me put the caulk in, really?
That's right.
That's wonderful.
All right, so you have a good day, man.
Thank you, son.
Bye.
Syndication now.
Opie and Anthony are finally syndicated.
Woo-hoo!
And to celebrate, they're going to be at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island tonight with Dr. Dirty, Mr. John Balbi. The show starts at 9 p.m., so come on down and hang with the guys tonight at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island. From 102.7 WNEW.
Hey, Anthony, Ultimate V.
I want to go home.
Ultimate V.
Ultimate V. You try any Ultimate V? It's great. It's a different product. Clinical findings tell us that the herbs in Ultimate V have the same effect as the leading prescription enhancement product. And you know what that is? Ultimate V is a serious product for people who are serious about sex. Makes good sex great sex phenomenal. Ultimate V guaranteed. No risk. It works. The packet right in your pocket or wallet. Fits. Very convenient. And the best part, it's for men and women.
Sweet.
Ultimate V is great for women. You'll never hear, stop that. Don't touch me anymore. This is against my will. They're just like roofies. No, I'm teasing. Ultimate V, she'll want it all the time. 888-808-8800, 888-808-8800. Go to the website, ultimatev.net. Tells you everything you need to know about Ultimate V. You used to fantasize about sex like this, didn't you? Not anymore. What are you waiting for? Be ready for anything. 1-888-808-8800 for Ultimate V.
Hour. By Opie and Anthony. Serving New Jersey, Connecticut, Long Island. This is 1027 WNEW, New York.
Hey, what would carbon sound like smoking pot?
You guys, I'm so relaxed right now. Can I get a cookie, please, man? Man, can I get a cookie?
I want a scooter pair. Man, can I get the pancake during the pair? Hey, sweet. Everything looks so good. Look, you guys. Costa Rican prostitutes. I'm so high. I feel like I'm floating.
And we're back with the Opie and Anthony Show, 877-692-1027.
Friggin' fag, you want to make out or something?
Mario Cantone in the studio.
That was great.
That's one of his bits, Cartman getting
that's
high.
I don't even remember what I did when I did that. That's
yeah.
That's because I was just staring, you guys.
It's so weird. That's bizarre that went on like that.
Do you do Cartman on stage, though?
Once in a while.
A little bit?
Yeah, I do him in the vagina monologues.
My vagina kicks ass.
Yeah. I do a little bit. People, but, you know, it's weird to do. I mean, I love doing them, but it's weird because it's not my character. It's Trey Parker. So you just feel like I resisted it for a long time.
You do it really well. I mean,
with the encouragement of Opie and Anthony, my Cartman has come out of the closet. Get your balls out. Slap your penis. Pinch your scrotum. Ouch! It's a day. Can I just tell you that?
That's my favorite part.
A man drove by the other day going, get your balls out. This big, like, straight, like, guy, like, with tattoos, get your balls out. With his thumbs up, like, and then three guys in front of Nobu the other day, do we want Opie and Anthony? We take a picture with them. I'm like Norma Desmond. I'm like this old husband just going, where are the boys? They all want to take pictures. Max, bring in the champagne and the caviar.
We got to tell everyone, Mario Cantone playing Caroline's tonight, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday.
Yeah.
Very, very.
You'll laugh your balls off.
Hold on, Louis.
Very, very.
Look who's here.
Louis Black. It's Margo Channing.
Louis Black has entered the parterre. Hold on one sec. Matt, what's up?
Yo, what's up, guys?
Hey.
Yo, welcome to Philadelphia.
Oh, thank you.
You guys rock.
Thanks.
Listen, the Philadelphia censors are losing their ass over here.
Why?
They are ripping the show up.
They're cutting it up.
They're dumping out all the time.
Like what part?
The cock stuff barely got through.
Are you kidding?
I'm not kidding you. And the second song that the guy did?
That should have been dumped out. John Valby?
Yeah, well, they didn't.
That one, yeah.
The thing on the back says, I'm a Jew, kill me.
I'm a Jew, kill me.
Unbelievable. Luxie, Mississippi is the only place in my entire life where these people went berserk on me in the audience. They were like, you know, they were heckling to the 10th power.
Really?
I finally said, look, you know, I said, will somebody walk him? I was in a place called Knuckleheads. That'll give you an idea.
Knuckleheads.
He said, we're going to walk together. They said, I basically had to walk him. And they left, and apparently, once they were out, I was finishing up. And everything went great once they were gone. And the manager came in from the casino and said, I wouldn't go out there if I was you. So finally, when I went outside, they had waited outside for me. I'd been in the...
We're going to get that Jew boy.
Well, it was... No, they said, you know what we're going to do to you, you New Yorker, you. And I thought, you know, they're not even bright enough to know that I'm a Jew. You know what I mean? It was like,
damn, if only we knew he was a Jew, we could have called him a Jew. Yeah. Instead of just New Yorker, you know, because, hey, Jew sounds better.
I don't know how you have the balls to go down there and do it. This is why I'm poor and I live in New York and I stay here. I can't go anywhere else and do it. I don't want to go anywhere.
It's a part of my outreach program.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
I love it. I mean, I love taunting them. I mean, I go down and talk about evolution. I say I'm not. I do in Southern Baptist areas. I discuss, the fact I'm not going to argue evolution anymore. You people are idiots when it comes to this.
Oh, great.
The fact that you let your neighbors run this area and they don't even believe. I said, they don't believe in evolution? Why are you talking to them? Evolution is a small part of the thing I like to call reality. Hello, fossils, we win. Shut up.
See, now he's knocking Christ the Lord. First his people done killed him.
You know,
now
Jim,
he's got a bad mouth.
I really feel, Jim, you know, I feel really honestly that Jesus loves everybody. He really, really does. And, you know, when I was married to Jim Baker, you know, we had a good marriage. It was difficult, but he wasn't a crook. But Jesus really loves you. But I love gay people. I really do. You know, Jim Bullock and everybody, I like them too, you know. And I even like all the Jews. I really, really do. I really do. I think I got a Hostess cupcake in my eye.
Anthony, what's going on?
Yo, what's up, fellas?
Hey.
Listen, I just got to tell you, every time I hear this guy Mario's voice, I have to cringe. He's a very funny guy and everything like this, but when I was younger, I think it was Sunday morning's Steam Pipe Alley.
Yeah.
And my mother and father would be drinking their coffee or whatever, and every time the friggin' show came on, every single week they would hop up, put me and my brother in front of the TV, give us juice, cookies, candy, everything, and go in the bedroom and have unbelievable, crazy long sex.
Well, see,
I swear to God,
you were a babysitter for parents that wanted to have sex.
That's unbelievable. That's a horrifying thing. But you know what? At least they were having sex with each other and not with, you know, whoever. It's a good thing that they were obviously they loved each other.
It was like Steam Pipe Alley was on, and now they can go have
sex. Do I beat Tenement Beach?
Your father was giving your mother the Steam Pipe Alley.
Yeah, really.
You say holy shiatsu foot massage, and you can get away with.
Don't leave the couch. They're like, me and Daddy are going into the room to talk.
Oh,
here's your juice.
To pow wow and pow plow.
Yo, guys. Thanks a lot, well, and let me just say, what's up, Boogie Nights, the real Boogie Nights.
All right, Anthony, thank you.
Hey, a little code going out.
Hey, you guys want to see Bob Crane having sex?
No.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Is there a video?
We have a website that we go to and see video clips of Bob Crane.
From Hogan?
Colonel Hogan. Once again, digging some tunnels.
Yeah, he was supposedly like Mr. Bang Bang, right?
He made his own pornos. His son, Scotty, is putting all these flicks on the website.
Yeah, that's where I didn't have children.
This is back in like the old days where you couldn't just pick up a palm cord and tape yourself having sex. He's running around like Ed Wood setting up these cameras with the big reels of film on it. It's like it was a pain in the ass to film your own video about your own porno back then. But we saw some earlier.
How is it?
And we learned Bob Crane has a peeler.
A peeler, yeah.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
And he's a shower and a grower.
Yes.
And
really?
Yeah. He was packing a lot then.
And he's very delicate when it comes to
the peach?
Yeah, the peach.
Yeah, he was
delicate when it comes to the peach.
He was dining.
He was dining. And his style, very delicate.
Was it a New Jersey white peach or a Georgia yellow peach?
Believe me, back then, it was the girls, they didn't do what they do now. There's a lot of waxing going on and hygiene and all types of hedge trimming going on. But back then, I swear, when he moved his face into a certain area, you ever see the episode of Gilligan's Island where it was Evil Gilligan with the big goatee? That's what he looked like.
Hold on one
second. He looked like the evil Bob Crane.
Dry heat. Wait, there's a little more.
God damn.
All right, I'm good.
All right, listen.
Where is it?
We got to show this guy Bob Crane.
Bob Crane. He's a shower and a grower.
A shower and a grower.
His penis is afloat at the gay pride this weekend.
Some people are just growers. Some people might not be impressive just showing, but it's like, wow, what a surprise.
Right.
It's a grower.
Right.
So he's a peeler. So
he's a peeler.
He's a peeler.
I'm not getting
a peeler, you know, like a cannoli. Now I just need the, I got to go to the members area.
Oh,
now,
you're
Rick,
going,
if
you're
you
going
would,
there.
If you would enter the code in, okay.
We're gonna have Scotty Crane on the show next week. Bob Crane's son.
Right.
Yes, Louis, you gotta go.
What's
over
he doing? But what is his son doing? I mean, talk about it.
He has a son that hates his father.
He's making money off his dad's porno collection.
His dad would have loved this. You know, his dad had been thrilled.
All right, yeah. Here's some of the videos we can choose.
Lewis, come on over here.
Let me see you guys. Okay.
All right, let's get right to some action with this one.
Don't give that out.
Yeah, we won't give that out yet. Because it'll slow down.
It'll slow down our viewing.
But his son thought it was great to just take these old films of his father having sex and release him to the public.
You mean he's actually releasing?
Yeah, Bob Crane, his son. Here's one of the lovely ladies. It looks like a... And here comes Bob Crane. Here comes Colonel Hogan. There he is, giving her what he likes to call the LeBeau. Now he's giving her the Schultz. When he gets to the Colonel Clink, that's great. That's when she needs a monocle in her eye because of what's coming at her.
Ah!
Look at that. Little bit of Bob Crane... having some doggy, big doggy style.
How do we know?
We know it's Bob Crane. Don't make me go to the still pictures. Because I'll do it. I'll go to some still pictures.
Give him the one still, Ed. The one still.
We know it's him.
Bob Crane. All
right.
It looks like Bob Crane in 19...
Visit our photo gallery. You tell me this isn't Colonel Hogan.
Oh, my God, it's Colonel Hogan!
Colonel Hogan getting a little... oral satisfaction. That's Colonel Hogan.
I cannot believe that.
And then what happened was in Arizona in 1978, somebody didn't like what he was doing with one of the girls he was doing something with and actually beat his head in with his own tripod from his camera, killing him. That's how Bob Crane died.
Show him the peach thing.
It is one of the most educational programs.
It is.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah, well, that's why I come in here, because I, you know, this is kind of, I heard about this.
Which one is the peach eating video?
Well, it looks like it was filmed during World War II.
It was back in the 50s, so you got to figure, you know, it wasn't like a camcorder.
No, I know. But
this was very...
film.
Look, it's like a snuff. There she is taking care of Bob Crane. She's got the black strip over her eyes, yeah. So you wouldn't know her now as she's like 80 years old.
Yeah.
Look at that. Nice technique, though, on her. She's really working Bob's crane.
I cannot believe this.
And let me see if I can find the one of him dining on the peach.
Look at the peach. I'm looking forward.
Is that this one? Yeah, no, I can't remember. I'll just go through a couple.
Now, figure this out. We can't solve our energy problems, but I can get Bob Crane's pecker in a tenth of a second.
Right. Isn't that amazing?
Hello, a dead man's pecker can come back. But we can't figure out what to do about energy.
Oh, here it is. Here he goes.
Oh, good.
That's not a peach. That's a peach cobbler.
Look at him go. Look, he's snapping.
That's a pool rack filled with afro hair.
There he goes. Isn't that something? It's Bob Crane, for
Mario,
God's sake.
Look, Mario. Look.
Look, Mario.
Don't make me. Look. I'm looking.
Look, damn it.
Judas Priest.
Mario, that's disgusting.
It's so gross.
Mario, that's hot, right? That's hot.
There he goes.
Right?
There he goes.
Oh, it's hot.
He's back in it.
It's hot. I want to see this. Oh, go back. Rewind. I want to see that again. Let me see that again. Oh, look at her. She's so hot. Let me say, I'd like to do her.
You know what's funny about this?
I want to do her.
You know what's really strange?
I want to plow her field. You know what I'm saying?
Look at close-up.
Close-up. Look at that. Look at his tongue. Look at
You know what's strange? He was supposed to actually be locked up in the POW camp here, but in order to get to this girl's peach, he snuck out through that tree stump and climbed out, and Colonel Clink never knew he was out gobbling a little bush. He was back for a roll call in the morning.
I'm smelling something funny. Is that in, like, smell-o-vision? Clink, you are a fool. Do you know what Hogan is doing when he is supposed to be in the barracks?
No, General Bogota. Chloe.
Yes.
What's up?
Hey, I'm just driving on the West Side Highway.
Okay. What's going on?
I had to call up because... You guys are hitting bigger markets now, and, you know, you have a lot more listeners.
Yeah.
And you got these wow stickers, and all I see are these girls whipping them out, my boyfriend whipping them out everywhere here and there. I think it's time to start promoting the guys whipping their, as you called it, junk out on Wednesdays and flashing it at me.
We've talked about
this. All right, believe it or not, we did talk about this, but, you know, to try to get the ladies a little thrill on the way home from work. But the problem, and all right, why don't you take this?
I'll put it in perspective for you. Guy's driving down the road. He's got a wow in his car.
Okay.
Girl feels inclined to pull up, sees the wow, opens up her shirt, shows the guy beautiful breasts,
The guy's happy. It's just fantastic, right?
Right.
Okay, now here it is. Girl's got a whatever sticker on her car, meaning that guys pull their junk out. Guy pulls up next to him, tries to drive and pull his junk out, which right there shoots away. Bad. But if he can do it, he does it. All of a sudden, within minutes, he looks in his mirror, and what's coming behind him? No one's happy.
No
one is happy. He's being beaten, wrestled to the ground, cuffed. Because for some reason, pulling your junk out and showing it out your window to ladies is a felony.
Right.
But
really?
Showing boobs to guys is cool. Everyone likes it.
Well, I've seen enough guys, you know, at the beach and everything showing their hairy chests off. I think it's just time, you know, they return a little favor. Well, maybe we could have a special section of Manhattan for, like, where you can whip out the junk.
I don't think a lot of guys, girls just want to see guys limp junk.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, you know, maybe you and or Opie and Anthony can be the fluffers. You guys can have like a fluffer day.
Now you're talking logical.
That's what I want to do. Fluffer day, and Opie and Anthony come down and fluff all the guys.
There you go.
Yeah, you're fluffy kind of guys.
Yeah, we'll be fluffers.
Yeah.
Hey, we have to take a break. But is Annoying Laugh Anthony still here?
Why?
Oh, he did leave?
Thank God.
He left.
Right. He left crying?
Because we got to play the dart thing for Philly and Chicago.
Yeah, we threw darts at his bank.
We were supposed to play this an hour ago.
Did they land?
Mario Cantone's horrible.
You all right, Mario?
I'm fine.
We're not going to throw darts at you.
No,
right?
I know.
He wanted to plug his limo company.
I know that.
And we said, in order to plug it, we'll give you 3 plugs per dart that sticks in your back.
Oh!
And he stood there. We protected his spine with some rolled up newspaper.
All right, that's good.
And I lobbed one right into his shoulder blade. And it stuck.
It stuck.
And he went, it let out a scream. Bong. It was horrific.
Yes. So we just want to play a little taste of this from the ONA archives as we go to break.
Yeah.
All
perfect.
Right.
All right, go ahead.
And
remember, if it doesn't hit your back,
no!
You don't get the plug.
Oh!
Is he bleeding?
Oh, there's a hole in his t-shirt.
That was a great shot, man.
Oh, yeah. I put that right in the shoulder blade.
All right, wait.
Right in the effing shoulder blade.
All right, 3 to go.
This should be good. Opie's pitching. Opie!
Wait, he gets a plug for that.
I forgot where I work, the pain.
Vital Transportation, 1-800-GO-VITAL.
God, you are a puss.
All right.
You're taking
Give
darts.
Him the mic.
All right, Opie.
Opie's pitching from the Little League mound, so this one's going to hurt a lot more.
Yeah, Opie is really close.
God. No, because I know what he's saying. He's gonna.
No, don't turn around like that, Anthony. He's gonna put an eye out.
Don't
stop. I'm very injured.
Move your head. Rick's pretty close too.
Opie. Wait, I want to go for. No.
Don't. All right, that's it. That's a tough shot, Opie. It's a little low.
You suck.
Oh, he nailed him in the love handle.
Man, nailed me right in the love handle, man.
Wait. This is the most fun you can ever have.
You see that dart bounce off that love handle?
I get a plug, right?
Yeah, you get a plug.
Didn't even stick in.
No. Top-notch love. 516-756-1663.
Oh, look at you.
Radio voice. Shut up, Nicola.
Make it stick.
Make it stick.
Come on.
$10 if it sticks.
No! No! Come on, Ed.
Oh! It's caught.
All right. Wait. Hold on. Ask the room officially did that one stick.
No,
it caught,
dude,
but it didn't.
We have blood.
We've got blood.
Syndication now. Opie and Anthony are finally syndicated.
Woo-hoo!
And to celebrate, they're going to be at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island tonight with Dr. Dirty, Mr. John Valvey. The show starts at 9 p.m., so come on down and hang with the guys tonight at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island. From 1027 WNEW.
You'll love Paisano.
Paisano.
Paisano, Mulberry Street in the heart of Little Italy, yes.
Right there in the heart of Little Italy. You know, when I take my family out, we usually go to Paisano on Mulberry Street when we're in the city. It's right there in the heart of Little Italy. All the romance of Italy, warm, friendly, relaxed restaurant. They serve incredible, authentic Italian cuisine made from old world recipes and priced right. The portions are huge, too. And they have the incredible pasta lunch specials. Where's Joey been?
He's been around. He's been calling.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, at the restaurant. I go down there. I expect to see Joey because it says, just ask for Joey, the owner. You get a glass of wine on the house.
But see, we should have people ask Joey if he likes it big doggy style.
Big doggy style. Ask for your pasta big doggy style at Paisano and Mulberry Street. 136 Mulberry. Call him 965-1188. 965-1188. Open 7 days a week. Weekends till 2.
Catch the best and of Opie and Anthony. Saturdays 11 to 3. 1027 WNEW.
Hey, Mario.
Yes?
You can handle some Van Halen, right?
I love Van Halen. Rock on.
Rock on.
Rock on. M.F.ers.
Hey, it's no Judy Garland, but you know.
Yeah, can I say one thing that I absolutely hated this year? Yeah. Did anybody see Moulin Rouge?
Yeah.
It sucked my dirty stardom. I hated it so much. I hate her. I hate her. And you know, let me tell you something.
Who's in Moulin Rouge?
Nicole Kidman.
Oh, okay.
And let me tell you something about Nicole. Let me tell you something about Moulin Rouge.
Can I just tell people that we're back with the Opie and Anthony show?
Okay, sure, go ahead. I'm
877-692-1027. We just got to get that out there. Now go. Continue.
Everybody I know that saw that movie loved it. Moulin Rouge.
Rouge.
And I'm going to tell you, it's so ridiculous. And the music has nothing to do with the period of time that it takes place in. It's flashy for being just... for being flashy. She is the coldest actress in the country. And you know who's made that movie like a number one movie? The same morons that like Madonna. The same prideful morons that like Madonna. That's who's made that movie number one. And it's a piece of shiatsu foot massages. It really is. I hated it so much. I wanted to kill.
I think the music video of the
food is a contender.
Yeah, I think that helped out.
Yeah, it helped out. But let me tell you something. When Patti LaBelle sang that and I am so sick of hearing these singers with their riffy voices. Can you sing a straight note for once? For once? I was in the subway today, and I hear this girl, thanks to Mariah Carey and Christina Aguilera. I mean, that's all you hear is, and then a hero comes. Can you lift it and straighten it up? That's all they do is riff. They think that's singing. And Cisco with his dragon, that other one, don't get me started. Cisco, how many S's in so, yeah, go ahead. You like the ladies. And this is for all the ladies. This is for all the ladies in the house. If I hear that one more time, what about the fags that may want to hear it, okay? This is for all the ladies in the house. Shut up. It's for everybody.
Friggin' fag, you want to make out or something?
That's the best part of the night.
That's the best sound.
It's so funny. All right, I had to get that out.
Hey,
Louis, wow.
are you going to go see Moulin Rouge?
I saw it. And he said everything, yeah.
Did you like it?
No, no. Well, she is Hillary Clinton. That's who she is. She's Hillary Clinton.
Yeah.
She's Hillary Clinton. She's a stone cold. And she, to me, she's like a fox. But you see her on the screen and you go, I wouldn't want to get near her.
No.
I don't get it.
No wonder
Tom Dumped minutes. There was 8 minutes that I liked because it was really fast. There was 8 minutes of it, the movie that I liked. And it was really fast, and they were going, it was really, really fast. And since I don't do drugs anymore, it was almost like a strobe effect, and then it stopped, and that was when the movie ended for me.
And halfway through it, I went, why didn't I get stoned before this? And then I thought, it wouldn't have made a difference! Okay, can I tell you what I did go see that I liked?
Yeah.
I have to say, I liked it, even though it's a big Disney bomb. I loved Atlantis. That was pretty great.
Atlantis? Oh, I thought you were going to say Pearl Harbor.
No, I hate that movie. I have not seen Pearl Harbor, but I am not going to sit through 3 hours and 16 minutes of a love story that I don't care about, and I have to wait 2.5 hours for, like, the aerial view of the bomb.
For the bomb.
I don't care. I don't care. No, I liked Atlantis. Atlantis, yeah. Go to the Ziegfeld. It's there. The last night is tonight. Smoke a big boat and go watch it. Sweet.
All right, listen. Mario Cantone's going to be at Caroline's tonight, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. You got to go see him. I'm telling you, he's hilarious.
757-4100. Reservations in time. I'm going to have no voice after
Philly?
Tonight. Philly?
Philly, do the road trip. Go see Mario.
Very funny.
I love the Philly cheesesteaks.
Look at you trying to fit in.
I do. I love Philly cheesesteaks. You know, Boston had good Boston had really nice cheesesteaks, but we didn't call them Philly cheesesteaks because they were made in Boston. So we called them cheesesteaks.
And Lewis Black in the studio from The Daily Show.
Yeah.
On Comedy Central. And you're playing Governors.
Governors, Levittown Friday and Sunday in Medford. Which only comes, it only appears when I arrive, and then Medford. They, like, come out of the dirt, and, like, they rise for one night, and they're there, and the town is there, and everybody's happy, and there's people who make shoes, and they milk the cows, and then I leave, and it's gone.
It just goes back into the pine barrens.
Gone.
Lewis,
it doesn't exist.
I'm going to go see you in Medford Sunday.
You won't be, and then, but don't, you'll disappear afterwards.
I may even stop by and see my aunt, who lives out there.
Really?
Maybe I'll bring her to the show.
Yeah, sure you will.
She'll dig you.
When was the last time you saw your aunt in Medford?
It's been a while.
Yeah.
No, because you can't find it. No one can find it.
No, she's the
even the limo driver can find it.
She's the cool aunt.
Nobody knows where it is. Nobody. You ask. You live on Long Island? Yeah. Do you know Medford is? No, there's no Medford in Long Island. There's a fruit fly named Medford.
There's a Medford in Massachusetts.
Yeah.
That's the Medford I know.
And that's where it belongs.
Yeah. Only they call it Medford. Medford.
Where you live, Medford? You know, remember, you know, there's a lot of girls, you know, Revere, like the girl.
Revere.
No, they say Vavia. They use a V instead of an R.
Vavia.
I was in a restaurant one time, and this girl was like, do you got any bread back there? Bread. Not bread, bread. You got any bread? Where are you from? Vavia. Revere? Yeah, Vavia. Bread? I need some bread sticks. I love bread. I want to dunk my bread in gravy. It's really great. Like that V instead, it's very strange.
Yeah, yeah. That's odd.
Admiral Lagasse has a little of that.
Yeah.
He's like, don't go away, we'll be right back with some crawfish. We're going to kick it up with crawfish, onion rings, and some soda. He has a sitcom.
No, he's got a sitcom. He's got a sitcom.
I'm a desperate human being. I can't believe he has a sitcom.
No, I do. But why not? Why not believe it? Huh? How many times do we have to go in front of those jackasses? Parade our little wares. And they're like, oh, yeah. How long have you been doing this? 180 years. Oh, Emeril Lagasse. He's got a pot in front of him. Woohoo! Let's get him. Look what he does. He makes stews. Let's put him on the air. God, it'll be so funny. What's that thing he says? Pow, bang, whatever that. What is that dumpy thing he does?
Lewis, why are you so bitter?
Bitter?
Why are you so bitter? You were a porn director on Law and Order.
Well, yeah, that was my.
And that was on last night.
Awesome.
Law and Order.
Law and Order was a major breakthrough.
It was on last night.
Yeah.
Did you have to really think about the role, or did you just imagine you were back on the Voyeur bus?
I actually said, could we just do a thing where, can we have a scene where I, like, audition girls?
Yeah.
Hello? I was actually not the director, I was the producer, wasn't I?
Producer, right.
This was the best part of that. I'm Paul Sorvino's in that. You know Paul Sorvino.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
So Sorvino's there, and so I walk up to him, and George Zunza, who disappeared after he did this show, wasn't on. And but Sorvino, it's his first day on it. And I'm like, Mr. Schlepp, I've never done any of this stuff before. I walk up to Sorvino, I go, you're doing this? I thought, I did this because I thought George Zunza was going to do it. I went, oh, son of a God. And I walked away. And he was like, God, I'm sweating about. And he started yelling. He went up to people, and they said, well, no, Mr. Black's a comedian. So then, for the next 5 days, I had to listen to every joke he's ever told.
Don't tell him.
Oh, man.
Don't tell anybody what you are. You're doing dramatic work. Shut up. Because you will get material from every corner of the studio.
Did you hear this one?
He told you a million jokes, right?
Oh, yeah. No.
Jesus, tap dancing Christ.
We're not supposed to be mad that Emeril Lagasse has a sitcom. I mean, what planet am I living on?
These guys get
and then that girl who does Survivor gets the thing.
She's in the animal.
That idiotic pig who won Survivor the first time.
He's got a radio show.
He's got a radio show! He was supposed to. They were going to syndicate him on the what's that? The Weasel Link.
That would be Richard Hatch.
You obviously can sing. I love her. I love how it gets shorter and shorter. Yeah. By the end, she's like, "You obviously can sing." I love her. I like, well, she's home. She's with her maid. You haven't cleaned the sink. Give her.
So you played a porn director or producer?
Porn producer. Yeah.
You know, you're
like, honey, lift it up. Lift up the breast a little bit.
You
should have
done some research with watching Hardcore.
Yeah, no, they
you ever see that movie Hardcore?
I saw Hardcore.
Did you put a bad hairpiece on or anything? Remember when the guy came in?
I had a lot of hair. You should see my hair then. Yeah. It was scary then.
Remember when the one guy came in to audition in Hardcore and the guy says, what's your name? Who was the star of that? What's his name?
George C. Scott.
George C. Scott. He goes, what's your name?
I'm Big Dick Black.
Remember that? And he goes, you're not our type.
You don't want hiring niggas, that's all.
Right? Remember that? That's from the movie. From the movie. And then my favorite, actually, if you ever
see it. I got it right here.
Oh, you got it?
Yeah.
When he's watching, because the whole plot of the movie is this guy's daughter runs off, goes to a big city, and gets into pornography, hardcore porno. He's searching for her all over. Finally, this investigator that he gets says, all right, I'm going to sit in this theater. I'm going to show you a film. It's going to be rough, but you sit and watch. He then sits and watches a movie of his little girl, his innocent little daughter, with two guys just being hammered front and back. Horrid. So here's George C. Scott as the father sitting in the theater watching his daughter.
It doesn't get funnier than this.
I love this.
Turn it off. Turn it off. Turn it off.
Oh my God! Is that horrible?
That's awesome! I saw that movie.
Oh
George
yeah,
C. Scott, George C. Scott.
That's a great movie.
He's riveting. He turns the whole thing green since Rec 3 of the New York Observer.
When he's just sitting there at first, he's watching. He's like, turn it off. Like, all right, just turn it off. And he starts shaking in his chair, grabbing the armrest of the seat.
Hey, what would Judy Garland sound like if she was watching Liza Minnelli in a porno?
who's that? Is that Liza or Lauren? Turn it off. Turn it off. Turn it off. Turn it off. That's what Judy Garland would sound like.
Mario Cantona, Caroline's tonight. Saturday, Sunday, and Monday.
757-4100. That's reservation at I love you guys.
Hey, we have an update on Stinky and his roommate.
Yeah, we were talking about this in the office. Stinky, of course, it's very hard for a young guy just starting out in life to get an apartment here in Manhattan.
These guys,
you know the prices. Oh.
These guys haven't heard this yet.
We just had a case here in New York where a guy actually killed occupants of an apartment because he wanted to move in. Killed them.
And threw the body parts out the window.
In the Bronx, no less. Not even in Manhattan. In a borough.
Right.
How nuts is that?
I can understand in Manhattan.
Well, that
somewhere
makes
nice,
sense.
Upper West Side.
Sense. That makes sense.
So, Stinky, it's very tough to get an apartment in New York City.
So, Stinky, for the pure shock of it, for Philly, Chicago, and Louis Black and Mario Cantone, tell everyone who you live with.
A 62-year-old school teacher that's a pedophile.
Is an actual pedophile?
Allegedly.
That's the word you are waiting for.
We don't know what he does with real people, but we do know some of his computer habits because of Stinky. He's trolling at night in his... give me the scene.
In his tidy whities.
In his tidy whities.
That's it. Just sitting on a hard wood chair in front of the computer. Wakes up.
Dark light in the kitchen.
You know, and he just gets on the computer and chats it up and goes on different sites.
You know, this is why you need places like a boarding house in New York, so you don't have to live with that.
But Louis,
he
has a really good view from the roof of his building.
And they share a room. I think we have some audio of
a room.
condo.
Yes, they share a room.
This is wrong. This is wrong.
They share a room.
You can ask. You can go, hello, I need help. Can you get me out of here? I'd like, you know, you've got people in who come in here to have darts thrown in their back. You can't find a room?
It's one room, and they have, like, little lofts on either side of the room, and Stinky's bed's on one side, his bed's on the other. We do have audio of right before they went to sleep the other night, his roommate.
Dear. Like having your back rubbed.
Wow.
Stinky, we need to set up a fund for you.
No,
like,
we don't.
Like an apartment fund.
We don't want
to
help him because it makes good radio.
Those men wanted to have sex with me.
This is radio gold.
It is. It's unbelievable.
So a bunch of us went over to his apartment last night to check it out.
Oh boy.
Yeah, there's what, about eight of us?
Like, excuse me while I whip this out.
One of the greatest lines ever.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Hey, man. Hey, Peter Polk.
So you guys all went over there? Yeah, and after we saw his place, Steve came up with this.
A quaint apartment in Greenwich Village. $500. A 15-minute subway ride from work to your quaint apartment, $1.50. A rooftop view of the entire New York City skyline, free. Getting to live with a 60-year-old pedophile, absolutely f***ing priceless. Some things Stinky can buy. For everything else, there's lifelong therapy. Brought to you by the National Psychotherapy Association and the makers of fine antipsychotic medication.
Now, Stinky, the apartment is as big as the studio, so he can't really escape. He just has to hang in this environment. What type of sites did you see him trolling on the internet?
The Danish pedophile site.
Danish pedophile site.
I cannot.
But then two nights ago, I go
disgusting.
Down to get a drink from the fridge.
It really is disgusting. I don't want to, like, make light of
he's
that.
He's on some site, but I don't even try to look. You know, I don't even want to know.
Uh-huh.
And I just turn around, and he goes, man, there's some crazy ass on the internet, huh? You want horses? And I was like, no, I've seen it all. Okay, thanks.
Oh,
I'm going back to bed.
How much time does he spend on the computer?
At least 8 hours a day.
Oh, my God.
He doesn't leave the apartment.
Have you checked the documents section or the...
I can't now. He has, like, password protections on everything. Steve even tried to get in.
Of course.
Oh, nice, Steve. The guy is sleeping, and we're hanging out in the place last night.
Yeah, giggling like friggin' girls. It's amazing we didn't wake this guy up and have him jump out of the loft with an axe.
I think he was bummed the guy was already in bed.
Yeah, why don't you have you guys see him without a shirt on?
Oh, yeah,
okay. All right, Stinky.
Hey, if I have to see it.
Stinky.
Yeah, those shagging pecs, I'm sure, are very appetizing.
And the horrible thing, he's a teacher.
But he's a teacher.
See, they always get into lines of work.
I pray that he just looks at this stuff and doesn't do it.
So he's such a loner.
This is
like,
really
he never
upsetting.
Leaves the apartment.
That's always the...
You know
over.
What?
Yeah, we.
Mm-hmm. It's so much better.
Mario, without playing our cards, we could tell you that we haven't taken this lightly. How's that sound?
I know you haven't. I know.
No,
you haven't
I mean, there's just say a lot of people listen to this radio
hey, you know
show.
What?
That
you
may
get
be
it
more
out there, and it's better that people know.
All right, we have audio.
Yeah, I mean, we went to jail because we're on a bus.
Right.
Hello, America.
With adult girls.
Yeah.
Albeit
unbelievable.
Teen girls.
Well, no, they weren't. Well, sort of teen.
Anthony, it's kind of sad, but after we left Stinky's apartment last night, we kind of put a dab recorder in and we captured some audio of Stinky crying himself to sleep.
All right.
I got nowhere else to go. I got nowhere else to go. I got nothing else.
Wow. Did Steve kick the door open and carry him out in his arms to a Joe Cocker song or something?
Oh. Cocker, I didn't even know her. Oh!
Hey, a little dice, thank you. You're too much.
Yeah. I can't believe you're still there.
More audio of Stinky.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm somebody's bitch.
Butt sex.
Sweet. Butt sex.
More audio from Stinky.
Oh, this is less fun than previously indicated.
I hate this place. Medications don't work. Nothing works here. I've been here for 7 years.
You see that Bellevue special on HBO?
No, I didn't. I couldn't watch it. I couldn't watch it.
That was a guy that just goes around. He screams this all day and all night.
I hate this place. The medications don't work. Nothing works here. I've been here for 7 years.
And now repeat a million times through the hallway. That's it. Yeah.
No. They'll repeat it.
Okay, listen.
Afterwards he went on. He's the guy who became the producer who gave Emeril Lagasse his thing after he got out.
More audio of Stinky crying himself to sleep.
I wasn't crying there.
Stinky talking to his roommate.
Your balls are showing.
Really?
Stinky trying to get away from his roommate here.
Oh, Billy.
Stinky trying to get away from his roommate?
Yeah. I would kick you in the nuts.
All right, we got to take a break.
You've been a delight and a pleasure. I have to go. I have a show. I'd sing them all and stay all night. But I
thought we were all having fun and stuff.
I'm having a blast.
Why would you want to leave us?
You make me feel really guilty. I'm going to tell you.
What do you got to do?
I've got a show in 2 hours. I got to go to Caroline's to do a test.
What are you, gay?
That too. I have to go to Caroline's. And I have to do a tech rehearsal, and then I have to go do the show. And I haven't even, look at me, I look like a bum, I haven't showered.
But I thought we were really, like, getting along, and it had nothing to do with, you know, the radio and stuff. Like.
I love you guys, I'm just gonna go. You're killing me, you're making me feel really, really guilty. But you know what, between the two of us,
we were gonna toast marshmallows and stuff.
Alright, I'll stay.
Don't make them all guilty.
You guys breaking up?
Yeah, it's over. You know, I have to tell you one thing.
Yeah.
Opie has a new look now.
No, I don't. Shut up, Lewis.
You have a whole new thing going on.
I'm supposed to shut up.
Shut up.
Poop Michelle's in a shirt. Since the new contract, there's a whole new look going on. He's ready to strut his stuff
down. Friggin' fag, you want to make out or something?
Get your balls out. No, you look great, actually.
Thank you.
I have
Mary.
To tell you, you look
Thank
great.
You,
you really
right.
do.
No.
Friggin' fag, you want to make out or something?
He turned bright red.
No, shut up, Lloyd.
You know why? Because he's inside that evil mind is a vulnerable child.
Shut up. Shut up, Lloyd.
He's a good man.
Lewis is enjoying this too much.
Yeah, baby.
From the torture I've gone through here, this is fabulous.
Right. Hey.
No, Rick.
Opie, you would like to say something to Mario?
Yeah. Can we see your stuff?
No.
Can we see your stuff?
All right, let's take a break.
Shut up, Lewis.
Look at Lewis is over there just dying in the car.
We're going to put you on another bus if you don't watch it.
All right. Opie, yes?
No. Can we see your stuff?
Sweet, that's big.
I got to get him off. Wow, I am getting pounded.
All right, Mario at Caroline's tonight.
Boys, thank you.
Mario, thank you again.
I'll be back
just Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Call for tickets, 212-757-4100, okay? Lewis, right. You're sticking around.
Yeah, I got no life.
Okay, good.
Syndication now.
Opie and Anthony are finally syndicated.
Woo-hoo!
And to celebrate, they're going to be at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island tonight with Dr. Dirty, Mr. John Valby. The show starts at 9 p.m., so come on down and hang with the guys tonight at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island. From 102.7 WNEW.
Anthony.
Yeah.
Bud Light.
You know, Bud Light. When you want a light beer, Bud Light recognizes that people from the Northeast, we see things in a different perspective, don't we? Who wrote this copy?
Lisa.
Oh, Leha. Here's the deal. I drink beer. I love beer. And when I want a light beer, it's always Bud Light. Why? Because it tastes like regular Bud. You drink any other beer's version of their beer in a light beer, and it tastes like watered down, and it's crap. You know, what about last night I pulled out of the cooler when I was hanging out at Aerosmith there with the parents. The cooler's full of that beer that comes in the silver can. That light beer, Opie?
I don't know.
I only know Bud Light.
Without saying the name, I'll just say Coors Light. And it was like urine water.
Well, it's made by Nazis in the mountains.
No, for a light beer that tastes like real beer, Bud Light. Bud Light.
Catch the best of Opie and Anthony. Saturdays, 11 to 3. 1027 WNEW.
And we're back with the Opie and Anthony show. Lewis Black in the studio. Our buddy, our pal from Comedy Central, The Daily Show. Playing Governors this weekend. Friday in Levittown, Sunday, the Medford Governors.
Pavilion.
There you have it. Toll free if you want to get a hold of the show today, 877-692-1027. My buddy BJ's on the line, Anthony.
Yes.
We were talking about the Bob Crane website today.
Yeah, Bob Crane's a son. Got a little website together with video and still pictures of his father having sex with various women. Because Bob Crane used to film and take pictures of all these women and him having sex. And pretty hardcore, this stuff. But we haven't spoken to Bob Crane's son yet.
No, he's going to be on the show next week, Scotty Crane. But we can't wait. And my friend out on the left coast talked to Scotty Crane. BJ!
Opie, Anthony, how are you, boys?
What's up?
What's going on, bro?
Hey, let me just congratulate you guys for spreading the sickness nationwide. Congrats.
Oh, thank you. We'd like to call it the ONA virus.
Audio AIDS.
Well, you guys deserve it. Well, not AIDS, but you deserve to spread.
Some people would think differently, but. So, BJ.
Yes.
Scotty Crane.
Scotty Crane is a nutcase. He should fit right in very well if you guys talk to him next week.
Yeah?
No. Yeah, he is. I tell you something, he's gonna bring the book with him, and it is the most bizarre book I've ever seen in my life, because you start off with the book, and there are family pictures of Scotty as a little baby hanging with his dad, they're at picnics, they're eating hot dogs, next thing you know, you're flipping over, people are eating hot dogs, but it's not the family picnic variety.
They're the Bob Crane plump when you jerk them hot dogs.
And Bob Crane was a substantial man. He was all, you know, Milton Berle substantial.
Yeah. Well, we've seen some of the pictures, I'm looking at one right now.
Let me see. Turn around.
It's the one with the lady taking care of Bob Crane.
Bob getting a knob job.
Yeah. As he's laying back on one of the many hotel room beds, I guess he's.
It's good to be Hogan.
Now, what's the deal with Scotty? I mean, did he hate Bob? Did he hate his father? I mean, is this his way of getting back?
This is the true hippie family. Bob loved it. I mean, Scotty loved his dad, and everybody knew that Bob was into this. You know who his mother is? His mother is Hilda, the Fraulein receptionist for Colonel Klink.
Right. Remember the nice buxom blonde?
Yes.
Yeah, that was the wife.
And she knew, I mean, I guess this was his second wife, and going into the marriage, he said, look, here's what I'm into. I like to put my pee-pee in women and film it. That's what I do.
Look at this one.
Yeah. And seriously, and Scott, you know, Scotty says he remembers at a very young age, his dad showing him pictures of him doing other chicks. It was like natural. It was just like, you know, hey, son, here's a microphone. This I do it on the radio. And by the way, here's a chick I diddle. And
oh, my God.
Yeah, it's nuts.
Very open family.
Knows.
That is wild.
Yeah, it's interesting. And Scotty's got, if he has the bit, I hope he brings it with him. He's got the sickest bit that he's done on this little like comedy show he does on our station about Bob's cranium, and it is a sick piece where people call in that are Bob Crane fans, thinking you are a sick bastard. How could you desecrate the memory of this man? And Scotty always goes, "Well, I can because I'm his son."
And how does the bit go?
Just, you know, something I have yet to hear it, but I just heard it. It was just, you know, he played on his show, and I heard it was like the sickest thing in the world. So I don't know if he's bringing it with him, but if he does, every time he plays it, he says he gets in trouble. I haven't heard it yet.
Yeah. All right. What else is in the book?
The book is really just pictures of him and his dad and women, and then. You know, it's just the freakiest thing. You're reading this book and you're going, okay. And there's a couple of stories about, you know, what Bob's his radio career was. He was like a big jock in L.A. And of course how he gets started into the movies and the TV and all that. Then he even at the end of the book, there's a picture of Bob's head bleeding all over a couch after he'd just been bludgeoned.
Oh, man.
I mean, you're going through it, you're going, okay, you're already shocked at the fact that you see, geez, I just saw the barbecue shot, and now there he is, you know, porking like three women. Okay, well, I can live with that. And then there he is, you know, his head's half off, bleeding all over the place, and that's the end of the book. Thanks for coming.
Nice.
I can't
wait to talk to this guy.
But he just published a book and came up with a site. So
the website.
Yeah. I didn't know he had a book, too.
Here's a quote from him. He goes, "This is my father. This is what he did. I've been seeing these photos since I was about 2 years old. These are my family photographs. We have nothing to hide, and nothing here justifies murder." Scotty Crane.
Well,
I guess if you're banging some guy's girl, you know, some people don't feel the same way about that.
He was killed with like a tripod.
Yeah, one of the tripods. And what are some of the rumors of who killed him?
Well, you know, so the only rumor that there was one guy that was brought to trial, and Scotty knows the guy and firmly believes, in fact, the guy isn't guilty. They really don't know. They don't have a clue as to who it could have been because, you know, it could have been anybody he was doing. He did so many.
Well, he died in Phoenix, right?
Yes.
And then there's 5 million suspects. That town, any one of those people.
The main suspect, though, is a guy that Bob was doing, right?
Now, see, I asked Scotty about that, and you can ask him again. You know, apparently Bob didn't do any gay stuff. It was all heterosexual stuff he was involved in. And that's the rumor we've all been hearing. But Scotty says, no, you know, Bob was just doing chicks and into filming people, you know, and filming doing chicks, and that's it, but never any guy action.
Have you seen the stuff on this website, BJ?
Well, I saw the book. I saw the whole book. I mean, whatever you see on the website, he's got in the book. There's just a couple of, shots on the website, and then there's more in the book. And the book is just, it's amazing. I mean, because I said, you know, you go from family pictures to hardcore porn to a death scene from NYPD Blue. It's just nuts.
That's unbelievable.
Man.
All right, Beach.
So that's it.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome, gentlemen, and again, congrats.
Thanks.
Thanks, man.
Take care.
Keep in touch, all right?
I surely will. And, you know, I'm pitching for you over here, guys. I really want you on our station out here, and I've been, nobody listens to me, but at least I pitch for you.
In Seattle.
Yeah, we'd love you. I mean, believe me, the people would love you in Seattle because, I mean, you guys have a great show, and they wouldn't know what hit them, but they'd love it.
Cool. All right, man.
All right, guys.
Thank you.
Yep.
There he goes.
Yeah, this would be the show to have in Seattle. They're like this close to suicide there most of the time, and you
put them over the edge.
No, we wouldn't put them. We would make them smile. The suicide rate would drop in Seattle if we were out there, Lewis. You're always looking on the dark side of things.
Oh, yeah, right.
You miserable F.
It's Mr. Smiley. Holy God.
Earl, what's up?
Hey, guys, we're just about to pull into Mulcahy's. My only advice to you guys is leave now. The LIR was practically underwater. It was pouring all the way down.
There's always some kind of
It's raining?
It was pouring.
Oh, wow. We should look out the window every once in a while. I thought it was a nice sunny day. I don't know.
It's pretty clear. It's gorgeous out here.
Yeah, cool.
We're about a block away from Mulcahy's, but, I mean, guys, leave now.
We have a radio show. We got a half hour to go, Earl.
Well, I know that, but, you know, put something on and leave now.
Oh, my God. All right, Earl. We're gonna be at Mulcahy's in Wantagh. Right after the show, we're leaving, and we're going to hang with John Valby. We're going to have fun.
So you're getting on the LIE?
Yeah.
That's a treat.
Yeah.
There's something I love driving on. You know, there's a piece of road that makes a lot of sense. What a jackass. Who's in charge of transportation on that stinking island? What, an alcoholic? Somebody, they go, oh, you know what, we got three lanes of traffic, we got a gazillion cars, and we're not going to move for 4 hours, so what do you think we should do? I don't know, have a double vodka.
One of the most populated cities in the world, New York City, it's one road in.
One road in. It's unbelievable. I always thought, and the wider and the further you go on Long Island,
it gets wider.
They have more lanes.
Yeah.
So turn the island around. Spin it around. It would make it simple. It would simplify things. Who the hell? Who gets in there car every day? What? How far gone do you have to be to get in a car every day and sit 2 hours on that thing without thinking I want a gun?
And I did it for over a year and a half.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah, I'm used to.
Earl.
I'm in Brooklyn.
You.
All right, thank you. We'll see you when we get there. Are there people there yet, or?
Well, if the van actually had windows, I'd be able to look, but I can't really tell.
So, Earl, basically you called to tell us that you're almost
at a location. I tried to tell him, but there was nothing going on, and he's like, yeah, hold on.
All right, Earl. Thank you.
Thank you.
Earl's reporting on his driving.
Another taxing call from Earl.
Earl is almost at a location that we're going to be at later.
My God.
This is professional radio, Lewis. You listen to the other stations. They don't have any of these problems.
Oh, man.
You go to the guy in the street, and he has his wrap down. It's like 60 seconds. They nail it, right?
Oh, yeah.
We get a guy calling because he's almost at a location.
And he can't look out a window.
Guys, I'm stopping for gas right now. I'm almost there. I've stopped. I'm using my mobile speed pass, which makes it a lot more convenient to fuel up on these drives to Mulcahy's, which I will eventually be at. Okay, I'm paying about $192.9 per gallon. And as I look, I'm up to about 11 gallons. I'll call you when I top my tank off. And I might even get some windshield washer fluid.
Just amazing. Amazing.
That's Earl. That's what he does.
We got to play What Did We Learn on the Opie and Anthony Show in the very near future. But
I think it was an educational show.
We didn't even get into the mayor thing, though.
The mayor. The mayor of New York City, Rudy Giuliani, he's involved in a huge, ugly, very public divorce right now.
Mm-hmm.
From Donna Hanover, that wonderful, wonderful woman. I am no fan of Rudy Giuliani, believe me. I despise the guy just like the next guy. But this twat of a wife of his is just beyond anything.
Yeah.
I mean, she is the C word.
Yeah.
And I'm sure Rudy has called her that and just pissed her off because you know how women hate that word. Shut up, you unt. Oh, I'd just love to see her start on fire, her head explode. So now there's a custody battle brewing. She doesn't want Rudy to have custody of their kids, one of which is the 15-year-old Andrew Giuliani.
Yeah.
Because
he's finally grown into his head.
Right.
Anthony, can I interrupt this rant for a second? Yes, Earl.
Earl.
Earl?
You know, Earl?
He wanted to tell us to screw off.
All right. Oh, boy.
Sorry about
that. That's the kind of radio I love.
Right.
Let's go. He starts a roll. Let's stop it.
Just stop it and go to the phones. We're used to it.
Let's go to
the phones. Because that could have been more fun.
Yeah, we don't care.
It might have been.
We don't know where the fun's going to come from, Louis.
You got to poke around for the fun.
Every time I come in here, it's another lesson.
Okay.
We don't know where the fun's going to come from.
We don't know.
We never know.
Sure.
They don't want to share custody because Donna Hanover, the wife, doesn't want her kids hanging around Rudy's hosebag girlfriend. What the hell's her name? Judy Nathan. Judy Nathan. This one.
Apparently, according to Jimmy Breslin, when I was at this political roundtable with him, he said the other night that there's another one. He said there's another
one. Oh, boy.
Can you imagine? He said that was I got it on good authority, and you know,
even
if
man.
It's not true, just Jimmy Breslin saying it makes me think it's true.
Right,
you know what I mean?
Right, gives it a little credibility. Yeah. So all of a sudden you're hearing this stuff, Donna Hanover saying that Rudy doesn't pay attention to the kids, and that's her whole ploy to get custody of the kids, and he pays attention to his girlfriend and stuff, and blah blah blah. You haven't seen Andrew Giuliani in years. Years ago, we saw a picture of him at a Yankee game. Where he almost fell out of the stands, the fat little kid, reaching for a ball. Remember that? And then, of course, we remember when he was inaugurated many years ago and Andrew was a little kid. He was jumping around at the podium while his father's being sworn in.
No, that was Chris Farley, I think.
Yeah, Chris Farley. He did that later on in a SNL bit.
No, Chris Farley's Rudy's son.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
He looks like him.
Little known fact.
So now, what does Rudy do? Right after that story breaks, here he is, golfing with his son and Tiger Woods.
On the front page of the... Daily News.
All of a sudden, it doesn't matter if you're the mayor, you got money, you're powerful. It's the same games that they play.
Yeah.
Like, all right, daddy's going to buy you this, daddy's going to do this. Your mom calls your daddy an a-hole. Your dad calls mommy a whore or a bitch or something like
now,
that.
How creepy must it be for Tiger Woods?
Yeah.
Go. You arrive at the course that day to do your practice round, and they go, "Yeah, you're going to be playing with."
It's got to suck.
Can you imagine
like,
how
the creepy... greatest golfer in the world, and he's got to like make believe he really wants to golf with the mayor's son.
There's not enough lithium in the world.
No.
Ah. Oh, now Andrew, you're playing golf and you'll like it.
I guess that's all I think. Like,
you'll get nothing and like it.
I want a corn dog and I want a hamburger.
Andrew. Hey, Tiger, do you hear the one about the colored boy, the priest?
Colored boy? Why, you son of a bitch? I'm just picturing a bad scene out of Caddyshack.
Hey, Mayor, where'd you get that hat? Oh, you get a free bowl of soup with that. Andrew, get your foot off the boat.
I don't know what you just... So poor Tiger's got to sit through that crap
and play a round of golf.
It's just to make him look like a better dad.
He doesn't want
to
play these rounds of golf with other people.
Well, you might want to meet some people, but I don't think you want to meet Rudy and his son, you know? And, he, you know, what is that about?
Hey, Mayor, I bet your grand you missed that putt.
You'll get nothing from me.
You know. And then I got that decency committee thing. You know, this guy is, he's not, you know, he's asked for this.
Yeah, yeah.
You
know, I know.
By saying, I'm going to put together a group of people who are going to make New York a decent place to live. I didn't move here for that.
Yeah.
You know? And so what did they, well, I mean, and then he gets, he's whining about this, but what do you expect when you're telling us, well, you know, you better live a good life. Well, kiss my ass.
Because you know? What's he doing?
What are you doing, you idiot?
The best thing is, for a 15-year-old kid.
On our dime.
Right, we're paying the whole thing.
You know?
For a 15-year-old kid, though, golfing with Tiger Woods, pretty cool. And now what the hell's Donna Hanover going to do? Hi, Andrew, you want to go see the vagina monologues? I'm in it. Ugh.
Yeah, Rudy got some brownie points.
Oh, yeah. But that's what you're just going to see this going back and forth in the news. What do we want to play? What do you learn today?
Yeah, we probably should.
Very educational program.
We probably should take a break. We're running out of time.
Yeah.
Oh, we're always running out of time. Well, that's what life is. You
know, there's not much time.
Lewis Black in the studio playing Governors Friday in Levittown, Sunday in Medford. And when we get back, we're going to play What Did We Learn on the Opie and Anthony Show? Great little game.
I'll bet you $15 the Giuliani kid picks his nose.
Saturday night, starting at 7, WNEW gives you Wheeze.
Hey, what's up, Weezer?
And Cheese. She's my 7 to 10, it's Brother Wheeze, endorsed by Opie and Anthony. At 10, Eddie Trunk cranks out the best variety of metal. And cheesy hair bands on Saturday Night Rocks. It's Wheeze.
Nice!
And Cheese. 107 WNEW.
Hey, Anthony, Sipperstein.
Sipperstein's. Don't miss Sipperstein's Get Cooking Sale when you get a red hot savings on paints and stains to make the outside of your home look great. Save $4 a gallon on Pittsburgh Paints Premium Manor Hall exterior and interior paints. Save $4 a gallon on fabulous Olympic siding and deck stains. Fabulous! Save $2 a gallon on Cabot stains rated number one. Not available in those home centers. Think you know what I'm talking about. The big home centers. Get a nifty three-piece stainless steel barbecue tool set with a $100 purchase and get a free Omaha Steaks cookbook. Maybe Emerald could use that one, Lewis, with a $25 purchase. See store for details. Get it all right now at Sipperstein's, where they've been helping people make their homes more beautiful inside and out for over 95 years. Still a family business, Sipperstein's has over 20 paint and decorating centers throughout New Jersey and Connecticut. So check them out. You'll save a lot of money at Sipperstein's. Get cooking with great price, great advice right now at Sipperstein's.
Catch the best of Opie and Anthony. Saturdays, 11 to 3. 1027 WNEW.
And we're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. It's time to play What Did We Learn on the O&A Show. 877-692-1027. Did Lewis Black get all his plugs wrong the whole show?
Maybe he's checking right now to make sure he's got the Medford Levittown dates right.
All right. Well, we can play What Did We Learn. All right.
Doug says he learned limo ant or annoying laugh ant ran out of there big doggy style.
Gator. Today I learned Medford doesn't exist when Lewis Black isn't in it.
Mm-hmm.
Jerry from Jersey, I learned the real hero was in Hogan's pants. And Cartman is now starring in the Vagina Monologues.
The whole city of Dallas killed Kennedy.
Right. Anthony from West Orange, I learned if you have two limos in a van, you can start your own limo service.
That's all you need.
Top-notch limo is a really good company. Catches a lot of abuse, but he really helps out the show, all right? I'd give out the phone number, but I really don't know it, I swear. So if he wants to call in, you know, we'll let him plug his company, okay?
Oh,
it's just 1-800-GO-VITAL.
Yeah.
But that's for vital transplant. See,
okay. Whatever.
That's what he wanted. That's what he asked for.
All right. 1-800-GO-VITAL. That's the limo company he works for. He owns his own, but he'd rather plug the one he works for.
I don't know what the story is.
Dan from Hoboken. I learned Bob Crane and Rick have egg rolls. I learned John Valby has to learn his ABCs, Anthony.
Mm-hmm. Dan from Hoboken again. I learned almost every topic that comes up on the O&A show can be reverted to a scene from Caddyshack.
Yeah, we like that.
Yes.
Tony, what's going on?
What's up, guys?
Hey.
I learned Shrek now does weather and traffic for NEW.
There you have it.
Lewis Black and Cantone killed, man. They got to do a bill together one of these days.
Without a doubt.
Great job, guys. See you tonight.
Okay, cool. Shay from Connecticut, I learned that if there's a window in the studio, then you guys would know that the sun wasn't shining chink yellow.
Swaddle doodle.
Ryan, I learned that if you're ever in a car accident, just say, it wasn't my fault, the light was blue.
The light was blue?
I learned that if I want to draw the sun, I need to use chink yellow. And if I want to draw flowers, I need to use homo pink from Grisola crayons. This is a tough one, Ed. I apologize in advance, okay?
What?
Ryan, once again. I learned that Met tickets, $50. Aerosmith tickets, $150. Anthony and his mom doing it big doggy style in the back of the limo. Priceless.
He's such a tool, man.
I learned that annoying laugh, Anthony takes it in the dooper.
In the dooper.
That's my new favorite thing on this show.
Das dooper.
Das dooper. I learned that Bob Crane looked like the evil Gilligan when he eats the peach.
Right.
Louis Black back in the studio. Did you screw up?
I'm an idiot.
You're an idiot.
Deficient. You know, you give, and what's left? Nothing. No protein for my brain. Medford Friday, Levittown Sunday, which makes no sense. But I was told that it was going to be the other way. So I apologize to everyone.
Other way.
So no one knows when. Now everyone's confused.
Oh, my God.
You know, that's
Lois.
All I need is that look of disappointment in your eyes. Like, it's not bad enough. I get it from my mother.
Because we're trying to help you out so people, you know, come to see you.
I know.
You're really, really good at what you do.
Well, my agent told me the wrong date.
It's not a shuttle launch schedule here, you know? It's your comedian.
It's really sad. And I had two dates to tell.
It's just
okay,
get him out there.
You're playing Governors. Friday,
Medford. Sunday, Levittown.
Governors.
And they'll call. I mean, hopefully they'll make the calls. You know, or not. I won't be playing Long Island. I won't be playing Long Island again.
All right, let's go to Katrina. Or Katarina. Katarina, what's going on?
Not much. I live in Monta. I was just driving by Mulcahy's. I see Earl. I'm all excited. I'm a big fan of the show. I pull over. I'm waving. He goes, you guys pissed him off. He wouldn't even say hi. He's like, nah, keep going. He wouldn't even say what's up. You guys pissed him off.
What's wrong with Earl today?
I don't know, man.
He's taking it to the storm bar.
That's all right. Don't
care. The F word.
All right.
You guys getting over here or what?
Yeah, we'll be there within the hour.
All right, I'll see you guys tonight.
It's going to be a zoo tonight, Lewis.
Nuts.
We're going to hang with John Valdi and Jim Norton at Mulcahy's in Wantagh.
Gator from Long Island learned that Sal wants to see Talica and Korn before the ringing goes away in his ears.
Anthony, on the instant feedback, I learned Lewis Black will be on Mars Saturday night. Let's go to Andy. Andy, what's going on?
Yellow.
Andy?
Hello, yes.
You're wrong.
I actually learned two things. While I was on hold, I learned that Lewis Black's going to be somewhere on Long Island sometime in June. And I also learned that Diamond Dust has a new look. Who's it be? What's your 20?
Diamond Dust has a hot new look, as per Mario Cantone.
It's the same look.
Friggin' fag, you want to make out or something?
Oh, man. Is Earl calling back? I think he's calling back.
Earl!
We have to end the show. No?
No? Is that not Earl?
Ben?
What?
Who? All right, sorry. We get distracted when the hotline rings. Paulie, what's up?
Hey, guys, what's up?
Hey.
I learned that Air Supply kicked ass at the Coliseum last night.
Yeah, Air Supply.
All right, guys, syndication 2 weeks ago.
All right, very good. Thank you. Okay, we got to get out of here.
I thought I was seeing Air Supply, Ro.
Man, that was fun today.
Yeah.
Good time. Tomorrow's FU Friday. If someone pissed you off, get a hold of the FU line on WNEW.com, okay?
Right.
Thanks, Lewis.
Hey, guys.
Lewis again.
It's always a pleasure.
I'll say it again because you need the help now.
Desperately need the help.
Friday night, you're going to be
calling, so they would know better than I know. Medford Friday.
Right.
When I'll see you, right. Maybe.
No. Screw that. Levittown's closer, so now I'm going to see you in Levittown.
You'll see me Levittown Sunday.
Yes.
Oh, great.
All right, okay. It's Governors. They have two locations.
Two locations. Medford Friday, yes. Sunday Levittown.
Oh, you're so screwed.
All right. Oh, man. I'm going to pay for this.
Syndication now.
Opie and Anthony are finally syndicated.
Woo-hoo!
And to celebrate, they're going to be at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island tonight with Dr. Dirty, Mr. John Valvey. The show starts at 9 p.m., so come on down and hang with the guys tonight at Mulcahy's in Wantagh, Long Island. From 102.7 WNEW.
Real fast, Big Doggy Dave, I learned that cursing to Valby is like crack to a crackhead. You can try to get him to stop, but it will only be a little while before he's smoking it again.
Yeah.
Bud Light.
Put light in the stumper.
Bud Light. You want a light beer that tastes like beer, then you want a Bud Light. It's the number one light beer in America. If you're going to the beach or a ballpark, whatever you're doing, Bud Light is the perfect companion. It's got a new look, a clear plastic label that you see right through it. See the cool, crisp freshness of Bud Light.
Mm-hmm.
We love it. You want a light beer, make it a Bud Light. So for the real taste, that won't fill you up and never, ever lets you down. Don't be fooled by imitations. Make it a Bud Light.
All right, we got to get out of here. We'll see you guys at Mulcahy's in Wantagh for John Donnelly. Jim Norton's going to do a few minutes. We're going to have stuff to give away. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
So if you're in the area, get your doompa.
Get on your doompa to Mulcahy's and poopin'.
What?
In the doompa.